decent against Mage. I think we saw it earlier in the run where we had Shamaners, you know, made totems, Mage couldn't really stop us, then we doom hammered him in the face, and he couldn't do anything about it. So I'm just bringing up the average here. Right now, 9 runs with Shaman, 8.89. 13 runs with Rogue, 8.46. So they're both performing very, very well. So really, I think I'm gonna, like, I said that I was gonna pick Shaman whenever I could, but I think it's up to you. You can pick what you want, because I want to play both.
I like Rogue right now. Like, right now, I, like, want to go back to the basics, and, like, Rogue is, I think, easier to play than Shaman. At least for me. Like, Shaman, I just, even when it's good, there's so much randomness built into the class that I have a hard time enjoying it. So I like the Rogue. There's a little,
we can pick Rogue, right? You can pick it. It's fine. I was like, just stay away from Crackle, and I think you're fine. I think Crackle's just the card that gets to me when I'm playing Rogue. But for the rest, I'm totally happy going with Shaman. It's just the I don't know. I feel like it's at its most stable where it's ever been, because you do get that ping in the early game, and even if you don't roll spell power, it's fine, right? You just get a ping. You get the good statted minions. You get Master of Illusion, you get the 7/7, you get the Fireguard Destroyer. On top of that, you know, there's still your good ass, your Fire Alley and stuff. So I think at this point it's just so many good things, it's just hard to draft a bad Shaman deck.
Yeah.
Alright, anyways, let's get this started. You tell me which card you'd pick and then I'll give you my opinion.
I think I actually like the Burgle here. I don't generally value card draw so much, but I feel like you can sacrifice the two spot in Rogue a little bit more. And Burgle's a pretty good card when it comes to draw. If you're looking for draw in Rogue,
I think so. Pyro is so good, right? Pyro wins a lot of games because it's really good.
Especially versus, I mean, it seems less useful against the mages, which is the majority of matchups, but for those that are drafting very aggressive decks, like for the mages, you know, those rogues, those shamans out there, Pyro is going to help win against those guys if we can get that effect off.
Yeah, I think it's super close. I think I would end up with the Burgle. I think it's fine. I think it's really close. But...
Yeah. I'm not sure if you've seen my drafts recently. I'd probably spend, like, you know, 4 minutes on this pick.
Yeah. But,
I think I like the Burgle here. Yeah. So are we fine with that?
Yep. Yeah, we've got Peddler being boosted as well, which is just nasty.
I don't like the Vendor.
No, I don't think. I think it's between the Schnick and the Crusher.
Yep. I don't know. I'm not sure what the percentage of matchups are against Mage for you. About, for me, it's about 30% right now.
I don't track. I track, but I don't track like that specifically. It's probably out there in the bot somewhere.
But. Yeah. I don't know. I've always liked a lot of one drops in a deck. Maybe too much. I guess. You know what? Maybe just go with Crusher. Something that is, you know, playable on turn 6. It's going to be resistance to the fire.
So I think that's super good logic. But I think that we have already picked this Burgle. So I think I'd pick the Pit Snake now and be a little bit safer against the other 8. The other 7 really against Rogue, it doesn't do that much. But it's really good against, like, the other 7 classes. It's really powerful. Even against Druid, just, you know, making them hero power that. It's really nice.
Yeah, this is a close pick for me. Again, like, I'd probably spend a few minutes on this. Anything that's anywhere near close, I like to spend a lot of time.
For sure. I think this was a very close one as well.
Buck?
Yep, easy Buck.
A simple pick, yep. Like those.
We like those indeed.
Sap, easy pick.
Sap, same deal.
Deck's looking nice so far.
So far, yeah.
You like the novice?
I like the novice here. Yeah, getting the cycle in.
Lance Carrier second.
Probably the bear second. The way I was going, looks like we're not going to be that on the board. But you know, obviously it depends on what we're going to get. But I've really grown to appreciate the smaller taunts more.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas the buffers are a little bit less for me right now. kind of pushes you towards a play style that I don't like right now.
Tomb Villager.
Yep. Premium 4, coins a good card.
DID?
Yeah. We don't want to do novice this early on, and DID is just better. So
yep. Okay, this is a little bit more interesting.
Yeah. So it's not the wrench. We're talking 2/6 or 5/0.
There's a lot of upside for Twilight Guardians right now. The nice thing about the Twilight Guardian and Netherspite Historian combo is that if you play that Netherspite, it will give you another dragon to activate your Twilight Guardian with. So you don't need to have multiple dragons for that synergy to get that taunt eventually off. If you end up with another Spite Historian, Doomsayer feels like kind of the safer pick as is, without any dragons in the deck right now. I think we could bypass a 4. So I think I would go with the Validated Doomsayer.
I think the Guardian is totally fine. I think that with all the Menagerie things out there, you've got Zubat, you've got the Magician, you have the Dragon Synergy cards in general. There's a lot of upside there. And I think that the Doomsayer is better in the Mage matchup because, you get to play it, survives Portal, and it pushes a lot of damage. Against people that are going to go aggro on you, it's really awkward to like squeeze it in somewhere, and then having the potential dragon and dropping that big ass taunt minion is really nice. So I think the Guardian will do here.
Yeah, I like it. Looking at it, it's like I think our deck, it looks like it's kind of handling those bigger decks a little bit better. We have Pit Snake, we have Sap. So how do we respond to those smaller decks? And getting a 2/6 out on turn 4 against a kind of a spread board can be really nice. It's also a card that can fit nicely with DID. So yeah, Twilight Guardian here looks good.
So I see people are asking questions, guys. I'm very welcome, and I'm sure Isher is as well, to answer those. But ask them after the draft, and then we'll very happily go over them. So just use @ShadyBunny or @Isherwood after the draft, and we'll happily go over them. Morshnik?
Yep, Pit Snake sounds good here.
Yeah, so obviously now Crusher would look okay because we have Twilight Guardian, but I think we're totally, we're still pretty happy picking out a Pit Snake.
I have not been hating, Pit Snake's a better card here in this pick, but I have not been hating 1-mana 1/2s right now.
Any particular reason?
Basically versus the Mage matchup, just getting something onto the board to start pressure early.
I feel like that's not the way to go. I feel like you run out of steam a little bit too fast if you're going to pressure that way. I feel like the mid-range approach is still better. Just really focus on not getting that 5 health minion out on turn 7.
That's a bummer. I'm always sad to pass up on an Iron Sensei because it's such a fun card. And when you can get it to work, it's insane. But when they removed Auto Barber, the chances that you're going to get a good Sensei deck decreased so much.
Even in the Barber era, I would have just picked Master of Disguise here.
I'd agree with that.
Double Pit Snake, it's actually really powerful. It's a really fun combo.
Yep, it's a good combo. Yep.
It's a Patient Assassin there. Dear God, Echoing Ooze by default. Let's go.
Yep.
There's never been a more clear pick when it's like Wrench plus Poison Blades. You pick the third thing.
I think I like the Ship's Cannon here, just because Rogue's 5 spot does have a few different bodies in there. We are pretty far into the deck, so if we want the 5, I understand it. I like the ships. We aren't on a good track for filling out our 2s, even though we can sacrifice that with the Rogue, but we do have a Pirate in the deck, so that little bit of synergy, Ship's Cannon is a solid enough 2.
I'm actually fine with how our early game looks right now. We have Ooze, we have 2 snakes and a buck. I feel if anything, you're going to be a little bit too light if you pick the Ship's Cannon here. So I just picked the Knight.
All right. We do have a Burgle to refill a little bit.
Yeah, but I don't know. It's like the way how I like to draft is I like to draft really careful and reactive, but that also means that you need the steam to justify that. Whereas if you have a careful reactive deck and then you play 2 drops, it kind of doesn't go anywhere.
Sylvan Knight.
Yeah, so this is kind of what those Pit Snakes are for, right? They give you that ease of mind that, you always have these little tempo things in the early game, and then you get to pick the heavier card because of those things.
Assassinate.
Yep, looks good.
Shredder? Or do you like the tiger? I mean, this is something that like I'm trying to speed myself up, but this is one where I actually like these cards.
Oh, for sure. I appreciate it because I mean, on one hand, I appreciate your thought you put into the draft, but I fear my audience has outgrown that.
I
have sped up over the past year, and that's crazy for people. You're like, Shady, were you slower at one point? It's like, yeah, I was way slower at one point. I'm trying to find a healthy medium between, you know, catering to the more entertaining side and then obviously the more in-depth thought.
So this is close. Let me actually put a little bit of more thought here. The thing is, like, both of these cards work well with you know, kind of similar cards in our deck. DID works well with both of these cards. Master of Disguise, potentially you re-stealth that tiger, it can go face again, you don't have to worry about that flame strike for another turn. They're both good. I feel like we have two cards that are pretty generally going to be pretty playable on turn five right now. Shredder is such a powerhouse on four. We might be looking to, hopefully we fall out of three spot, but in this deck when we have the coin, we might be looking out to coin fours. I think I like the Shredder.
Yeah, I think with a strategy like this, a strong four is key, where you kind of dip on two, you really need a strong four to get back on the board. So I think the Shredder is definitely the pick from here. With that in mind, obviously Tiger's good, but
yeah,
I think we have in mind that we really want to get this power for
Cult Master for me.
Yeah, not good for our archetype, but we'll take it.
But it's still, I mean, still
it's just better than the other two. So
yep.
And you know, if you put it down and exchange one dude, it's all good.
We seem to be on a kind of a, feels like a slower deck, so I don't think I like the Tinkers. I think I like the Swashbuckler here. So, Illusionist does fill in the 3D spot.
It's definitely never oil for me here, just because Swashbuckler is amazing. Mm-hmm. I think it has to be Illusionist, though, with 0/3 drops right now, and just, you know, the synergy in Rogue, the fact that this thing gives you a free ping, you don't have to pay the health total. I think that we have to pick Illusionist for that reason.
Okay.
Because we have 1/3 right now with just Buccaneer. I think the Illusionist makes it a little bit more consistent.
All right.
But yeah, obviously Swashbuckler is great. Love the card.
I think I prefer the Ascension over the Heckler with this deck.
Why?
I like the health a little bit more. We've got DID, we've got Cult Master, a few things that can perhaps that health will be a little bit more valuable on over the less sticky card.
So when you have to pick this on pick one and there's no class benefit to either, which one would you prefer?
Heckler right now.
I would agree that on a blank slate, Heckler's better. So the reason why Ascension could be better in this deck is, like you say, we are going to be playing into their stuff quite often. Doesn't look like we have a great lead on the early game. So I do agree with Ascension because we're going to be playing into their stuff. And I think Vile Illusion is a good example. Like, if he plays that on turn three, you feel really bad playing your Heckler into that. So I think Ascension will do for that reason. Yeah.
Right.
I like that. Good, good, good.
What do you think of Fork?
I think Fork's fine, but I think we're pretty happy you picked Illusionist last turn, and we can go with the Burglar here.
Ah, cool. I just wanted your general thoughts on it. I think it's a, you know, I think it's a decent card that doesn't feel overpowered in a good class. Kudos, Blizzard. Sometimes you do something okay.
Yeah, I think the Fork definitely felt like it was really bad when it got released, and then you play with it, and you're like, this is pretty good. Where you're like, the big thing about the Fork is that the weapon, you use it to go face a lot of the time. And when you're playing a little bit more neck on neck, the extra, you know, free deadly poison matters to get board control. So it's totally fine there.
All right. Interesting pick here.
Definitely. All of them are viable. We'll start off with saying that.
Yeah, I think I want to eliminate the Burgle first, as we have Cult Master and Burgle in the deck. And a Swashbuckler, it feels like we can refill our hand. Imp Master's good. It's a nice card to potentially set up into a DID or even a Cult Master. We do need some more threes. Bookworm feels like it's a card with a lot of upside here. We have a Twilight Guardian in the deck. If we end up with some Nether Spite Historians, all of a sudden we could end up with a very, very powerful, perhaps like Attrition Rogue if you get the right dragons out of those. But I feel like Imp Master is the pick that fits the deck the best right now, just to fill in the curve.
I actually feel perfectly fine picking the Burgle here. Simply because we have the Buck and the two Pit Snakes to supplement
fill in
three. Yep. And then it does feel like we don't really have a game plan right now for the late game. So I do like just picking up more card draw to make sure that if we live, we win. I think that's a big part of, you know, knowing how your deck wins, right?
This shifts our style, and I think at this point, like I think our picks are probably going to like line up a lot more now. I think this pick kind of puts us towards a condition where we want our deck to be. So yeah, we'll grab the Burgle.
Yeah, seems good. Yeah, I do get it though. I think the safe pick is totally the three there, but yeah. I think that the safe pick doesn't cut it. These days, I think you really need to be a little greedy and find your win con.
You like the teacher?
I think with the Burgle pickup, we can definitely consider the priestess, just because our turn two is fairly weak, just to make sure we have something in the early game. So I'm not sure whether it is, but
priestess and pit snake is that's not a bad coin combo. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think looking at our fours right now, we're totally fine.
Yeah.
And because of that Burgle, I just want to make sure, like, you can feel it, right? Even in the draft, yep. It's a constant, you know, I need to make sure I win if I survive, and I need to make sure I survive. So it's this constant struggle of not too much of one, not too much of the other, a good balance. And I think the Priestess here adds for a good balance.
Sounds good.
Yep. Obviously, Death Lord is okay, but I don't think we need to risk it.
I'd go with the Harvest Golem. Card is amazing with Dark Iron Dwarf. Nice lead into a Cult Master at times. We need a three.
I agree. Yep. I think Yeti's cool, but we have four mana cards, so.
Pick two, if this was the second pick in the draft, would you go for the Yeti?
Yeti? Yeah, definitely. Yetis are great. I think Power Fours are really, really important when you're drafting this slightly slower style.
I like the Tauren. If we, you know, it's what we said. If we live, we win. It's a card that, you know, absolutely. Sticky enough.
Yep.
DID, Cult Master, same thing. So Tauren?
Yep, Tauren. Definitely looking for some nice beef, but fortunately we are. Like, the deck is not really... I'm really happy you picked the second Burgle, because, like, the deck's not really steering us towards where we want to go right now.
Yep. I like another Young Priestess here.
Funny. Here is where I feel like we might get too light.
I don't think we are too light. We've got a bit of draw. Like if it was something weighted, like a five drop or a six drop, I'd go with it. But another four, I think it's not something that we need right now. I'd rather go with having a really consistent early game, whether that's just filling in with you know, one drops and two drops on turn two or on turn three. Something
so
like that.
Master of Disguise does synergize well with both our Pit Snakes. So does Young Priestess, but I think Master of Disguise a little bit more than Priestess.
Yep.
Is there anything else cool? We can stealth a Violet Illusionist, which could be cool. Other than that, I don't. Obviously, you know, just denying your opponent good trades is good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's go with the Priestess. I think it's close enough, and I think that this could make us draft really greedy going into the next seven picks. So
yeah, since we mentioned good stealth targets, Cult Master is also another one of those. But yeah, I like the Young Priestess here.
That is correct.
Assassinate?
Yep. As much value as possible. Slow removal.
Flame Juggler?
Yep. That's fine. Like, that's our first real two drop.
So. I started saying something and then I started skimming the deck really quick for dragons.
Yeah, I know. I was like, we've got one. I don't think that's right.
Shadow Strike.
Yes. So, just... come on, deck. Just pick things. Man, I so wish we picked that Crusher now, but yeah. Obviously, pick one or two. It's kind of difficult.
Yep.
Thespian? Okay.
I feel...
Sorry?
Oh, I was about to say, it feels a little odd not getting, like, have we been offered another 6-drop or higher since that Crusher?
I don't believe so. We're like, the draft's definitely pushing us towards this. Man, so Volcanic Drake is a dragon for your Guardian, but I feel like Swashbuckler is so good, I probably want to pick that.
Yeah, I feel like Volcanic Drake, you know, it is a dragon for the Guardian. It works. It feels like it works in this deck with the Cult Master. There's going to be times where you're incentivized to trade out the board, especially since we're going to want to trade out the board, then refill our hand and win that way. So I think Drake could.
You're leading Drake, or?
No, I think there's reasons for Drake. I like the Swashbuckler. I mean, I like the Swashbuckler for the simple principle as it's fun right now.
Yeah.
I've trained my brain to think very, very slowly. So like, again, this is a pick where I would talk about it a few minutes. Because I'm happy with trying out more burglars, I'll happily grab a burglar right here.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the thing is, for me, if Drake had 5 health, right? It was a 5 health minion, I'd settle for that, but
oh yeah.
Maybe even, I guess, Peddler, right? Like, I think you pick the Swashbuckler and just hope that you're
oh man, if we get Peddler last pick with double burgle, double, oh man.
That's the dream, right?
Yeah.
I hear that you always get rewarded in this game. Oh my god. I mean, yeah, good quality, good mid range for pick the Shredder, but
yeah.
Holy shit. I have to mention that Sorcerer is a dragon, but
yeah. And I like Lilian Rogue. I mean, hero powering on turn 2 as Rogue, it's you know, it turns out not a bad thing.
Validated Doomsayer would be so good here as well. But yeah, we're totally just gone in the opposite direction of what we wanted to. But we've been pushed into a super aggressive mid-range deck. the double burgle at least is really good. So yeah.
I mean, Peddler. The burgle's going to get... Oh, yes!
Boom! This Peddler, man. MVP. Okay. All right. So this is about as aggressive mid-range as you get, right?
It's totally the Peddler. I'm sad that we don't get to pick the Raptor, though, with double Shredder in the deck. Peddler.
Yeah, we need something.
We just need a bigger body, right? That's like more than the effect. If it was somehow you could get offered a Pit Fighter versus the Raptor, you'd still go with the Pit Fighter, even though the effect is really nice for this deck.
Cool. So substitutes we'd like to would have made. Definitely the 0 mana 7. Definitely the 5 mana 0/7. That'd be much better than the Twilight Guardian. Definitely the Crusher. I think that's about it.
Mm-hmm. Those were big cards that, like, I don't know. It feels kind of surprising. You don't always get what you expect in drafts. I would have expected, you know, we get offered something, a Boulder Fisto or War Golem even, but you know, we just didn't get offered those big bodies. But I don't know. I like the look of this deck.
I think it's fun. I think it might disappoint just because it's a little bit too light for my liking. Mm-hmm. It's definitely good testing, right? Mm-hmm. It's definitely good testing. You can stop sharing, by the way.
All right, that is the plus button again, and is it stop sharing? There we go.
Yep. And you can share your webcam if you like. That's up to you.
Okay.
All right, let me get you on the stream. There you are. Oh, I like it. Yeah. There we go. Definitely matching. All right.
Yep.
So I do have you on an A, right? Let's take 1 or 2 minutes to answer the chat, and then we'll get going.
Oh yeah, sure.
Okay, guys. So if you have any questions about the draft, if you have any questions just in general, throw them out right now, because we're gonna be starting the game after this. That Piddler was the single most likely card for pick number 30. Yeah, it's being boosted right now, and we knew it was gonna be a rare, and it's a class card. So. Yeah. We regret. Thanks so much for subbing. Welcome. Thank you. Thank you very much. Double shirt stream book jump. Yes. Isher tie. So people say, like, man, this is a really aggro deck. You're reading off the burst the opponents down. So the fact that I have 2 Swashbucklers and 2 burglars really changes the way how you expect this curve to play out.
Yeah, you're expecting at least one pretty big body out of those 4 cards. I way back when I first started playing Hearthstone and I played a lot of Constructed, like I ran Thought Steal a lot. When you run cards like Thought Steal and Burgle and you're used to those, you uh, you're used to getting a big body or two. I remember, you know, the days when I refused to run Dr. Boom in my deck, but I always managed to get to play a few with Thought Still.
Yeah. Priest and Constructed Dance Game. Oscar Fiasco says, I'd be terrified to have so many one drops. How many is normal for a mid-range rogue deck? So it all depends on what your two slot is looking like. So the reason why we have a lot of ones is because we really skimped on our twos. We ditched pretty much every two we could. We've got Pompous Thespian, Ooze, and Flame Juggler. That's our only real two drops. And then Ooze is like, you know, real, you know, not really that. So the fact that you have so many one drops gets a little bit mitigated by the fact that you have little two drops and your two of your one drops are Swashbucklers. So Swashbucklers make up for themselves. So it's really not as light as it seems. It's definitely light, but you know, you look at the curve and you're like, holy shit, this thing's out of card on turn four. But the fact that, you know, you're fairly low on twos and two of the one drops replace themselves. And then, you know, the Buccaneer as well, right? Buccaneer is more a three drop than it is a one drop. So
mm-hmm. Yeah. Rogue's a class that if, you know, if somebody was like, hey, I got a 12-win deck and I had 0-2 drops, that wouldn't be the most surprising thing to me.
Yeah. Like, I actually had a mission where I couldn't draft twos and went nine.
Yeah. It's just the power of the Rogue ones are really, really strong. I think the two classes that you can go the craziest with one drops in is Rogue and Warlock.
Yeah.
And I think our one drops are, you know, they're pretty decent. The Young Priestesses perhaps make the other one drops even better.
We have some really good questions here, by the way. Sure. We have a question here from Beast Haven and Wadi. So Beast Haven says, Shady and Isher, how do you guys analyze the decks after you guys pick and find out what archetype is this and find out what the gold is of the drafted deck? And then Wadi in the same region asks, what is it that makes this deck mid-range rather than aggro? Forgive me if that's a really dumb question. I don't understand exactly. It's perfect because these are more the more flexible concepts in Hearthstone and mm-hmm. things that, you know, are also subject meta to meta. What is aggro? What is mid-range? So you want to start by taking this issue?
What was the first one?
So it's pretty much tied together. Like, how do you know what archetype you have? How do you know what it's supposed to do? How do you analyze? Like, okay, so for instance, we both were like, yeah, so we picked this Burgle, and that's, you know, that's now how you said it, our thoughts are going to align more at that point. Like, how do you do it where you categorize that's that archetype? Like, this archetype wants to do that, that's why this card becomes better.
Yeah, I think a lot of it is, you know, a lot of it has to do with curve, what your cards are trying to do. It's at one point we passed up on a Tinker Sharp Soil Oil, and that's a card that when you draft that card, you're going to find yourself leaning much more towards an aggressive aggro style because the aggro deck's looking to win the game by pushing face as much as possible. You know, there's the term aggro control, which these phrases, like, I don't have the exact definition, but aggro control seems to be, you know, aggro with a lot of control style spot removal spells. So if we had backstab, tinker sharp sword oil, more twos, threes instead of this kind of clump of fours, we'd be probably looking at an aggro deck. I often find that's generally over time you kind of figure out, like, with the cards that you end up with, what kind of deck you can get. It takes a little bit of time with that, but like here we feel like we have a mid-range deck. We have a big peak on fours. We also have ways to refill our hand for the late game. So we're looking to win the game and kind of the middle of the game, right? We're not quite an attrition deck, which is what you'll see probably most likely from Mage and Priest, which those are set basically just wear your opponents out of hands. I mean, maybe we get there depending on like what kind of burgles we get. Because we can refill our hand late in the game.
Yeah, for sure. But that's kind of the more, indeed, the thing. So I'll give you my opinion on this, guys, is that the reason why this isn't aggro for me is that you're very low on reach. I think aggro is all about curving low and then having reach. That's a crucial component of aggro. I don't think you have an aggro deck without reach, because aggro loses the board and then finishes your opponent out of hand, or obviously, you know, goes really fast and it finishes your opponent while he's still on the board if you have a good start. Mm-hmm. So this deck is just going to throw quality four drops in their face. You know, we've got two Shredders, we've got a Pillager, we've got Dark Iron Dwarf, like really good four drops. So we're really looking to make a spike in that mid game, like grabbing the board and then taking over. So what mid-range does is it stops aggro, out-controls them, and then wins. And it goes faster than control and then kills control. So mid-range is nicely in between there, which is why it's my favorite archetype. It's it has enough control elements to beat aggro and just, you know, stop them in their tracks. And it's fast enough to beat control in a lot of the cases. And obviously mid-range versus mid-range is more of a skill fest where you have to really assess just how fast your opponent is and like what attitude you should take towards him. Like, should you be defending? Should you be attacking? So I'll focus a little bit more on that while we're playing. All right, Isher, let us queue up and get started.
All right, sounds good.
You don't play, you just talk? No, I was kidding. No, I like to throw that out because a lot of the people are not used to this. Obviously, I usually go a little bit faster, but when I got Isherwood on, I don't have him on very often. He's got a lot of good things to say, so it's good to take our time and talk about it. And honestly, like, you learn way more about this if you're listening, that is, if you're just sitting here like, God, when are they going to start clicking the cards? Then obviously you're not going to take much out of this, but I feel like just a talk like this where we talk about how we draft our decks, how we identify it, and, you know, just how we're... Oh, you have to invite me, by the way.
Yeah, sorry, I'll do that right now.
How you're playing that?
Yeah.
Like, you learn more from that than just watching us play.
Also, like, a thing to note, this is advice that originates from SimCopter. If you're unsure what your deck does, take that first game and really figure out what that deck wants to do for the rest of the time. Because sometimes even I'll misevaluate a deck, right? Like, I'll think the deck does something better than it actually does in performance, just because of like how certain cards work together. Like, really focus on the first game and take that opportunity to learn what that deck does.
Throw it all.
All right. Yep. Throw it all.
Yep. So one thing here is where if you'd be... Sorry, what were you saying?
Oh, I was just looking at Shadow Strike for a second. Is there any thoughts of we want to keep
that? Well, the form on a 7/7 and such, but we have so many ones. You really want to start fast with this deck. So the thing with this deck, which you could misinterpret, is that, you know, if you look at a curve, you're like, oh man, I'm super aggro, I'm super low curve, I need to go fast, fast, fast. But the fact that you have two burglars, two burgles, and just in general, your rogue, your hero power can get you some value. It can really, indeed, you can really misevaluate where a deck is going.
So my thought is coining a thespian here. That even without the spirit clause, coining the double ones would have been I don't think it does much. Getting that extra health on the non-priority target isn't that great.
Why don't we just put the burglar out this turn and save our coin for our power turn? Get that shredder out on three. Just, you know, throw the burglar out, dagger on two. Get the thing
going.
Sounds good. Yep. At the end of the draft, I made myself hot chocolate. Is this really the start of game one? No, we've already gone 0-3 and we drafted Superman. So. Oh, this is really good. AoE. That's all we need.
Yep.
Let's pass it up. Finally, here we go. Yeah, now we're actually limited by the rope, guys. So we actually have to play on some kind of a timer. So good.
Right. Thespian?
With that play, yeah, I'd go with the Thespian. I think there was definitely a world where we were gonna dagger, but this is fine.
So, depending on what we draw, looking to coin fours, it would seem.
I think, you know, we've got the sap for the 7/7, which is really great. Very happy with that. I think that's the most important part here. Just, that's kind of how they cheese you most of the time. Yeah, pretty happy coining the shredder. The alternative, you know, being either burning your sap or getting the dagger and the priestess out with him having the one damage just doesn't do anything.
Yep.
All right, I'm going to give you 10 Weezius, and then you can think about what you've said. And then if you want to behave, you can come back, and otherwise you can stay away.
All right, fine with an Ice Rager here?
Yeah, not a 4-mana 7/7, but I guess we'll have to put up with it. Might even Storm here.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. Like, the thing is, if it lands 2 on that Dragonhawk Rider, it feels kind of bad, I guess.
So yeah, let's look at what the alternative to Storm is here. We'd have to trade into probably the Wind Fury. Gets a lot of damage down. Burgle, I don't think, is ever a play here.
Yeah, it would be like we maybe sap. I don't think we sap here.
I think we just storm and hope the high roll. If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. It's fine. Unfortunate. I'm okay trading it, seeing what we get.
Yep. It's a taunt. We are more incentivized to drop the Young Priestess.
So next turn we're going to have 3 mana, right?
Yeah, we could hope he plays a 5 drop, he goes sap Priestess next turn.
Yeah, I don't think I burn the Priestess on this turn. I think it's fine.
Right.
So that was a decent value trade, but obviously there's a lot of tempo lost there with the overload. This is super annoying.
Not the 5 drop that I was hoping for.
No.
Is there an ordering that you can guarantee the 1 health on both of those oozes?
Well, the Priestess goes off first, right? If you play her first. So okay. You have to play Priestess first and then ooze. And then it's still a coin flip. But yeah, Priestess has to go first.
All right, so we want to play the 1 and the 2 here?
I want to play I don't think the dagger's worth it here. I think we need to put stuff on the board.
Positioning matter for us in this deck?
We have a Burgle, so I think it matters, yes. It doesn't really matter because the Priestess is getting dunked, but I think you just put the oozes in the middle and push 3. Yep. Yeah, I think with Burgles in your deck, your positioning always matters, especially against the class with Flame Tongue Totem. Oh, I think it worked.
Did we get it? Nice.
Got him. Correct ordering matters here, guys. Igneous says, why not just Priestess face? You mean Priestess dagger face or Priestess Burgle face? Well, not in that order, but... Oh, you meant you wanted to Priestess the thing. So... Then he gets the Wind Fury, start to do damage. I don't know, I didn't really like that.
Man, that rogue weapon, that shaman weapon is really good.
Sorry?
That Spirit Claws, it's a good card.
Yeah, a really good card. Definitely makes the Pit Snake worse here. So if we were to just Silverhand and Pit Snake and double bump, his face goes into the Pit Snake, his 4-3 kills a 4-4. He's got 5-2 versus a 2-2 and 2-1-3s. We could also Burgle here and sap the Shredder. What do you think?
I think I like the Burgle because we have options of finding either Lightning Storm or Hex. It's out there, but we have some really good cards that we could find. So I think the upside of Burgle makes it potentially worth it here.
Burgle's fine, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty close.
Stormforge Axe, remove the tiger.
Yeah, I think double bump and then take the 5.
Yep, do you want to play a Pit Snake here?
No, I think that with Master of the Skies in the deck and that charge being active, I don't think it's good.
Oh, we got another good card too. I didn't even look at Master of Evolution. That is
pretty good with the ooze as well here. Next turn, we're going to be able to sap and master. Oh, beautiful.
Yes.
It's really big. Telexas, thanks so much for the 3 months in a row. Appreciate that. Welcome. Da-da-da. 3 more for half a year, next milestone. Feels good. So, he still has that weapon charge, which is really blocking us.
Yeah.
If we evolve, we get a 3 mana card. I guess we should put an ooze in his face and then evolve it and go from there.
Do we want to pop the Shredder?
Bum, bum.
Potentially we clear if we're lucky and then evolve?
Good point. Yeah, I think taking the 4 is fine here. Yep. Throw in an ooze. I was thinking maybe we get something that buffs our guy.
All right, sap evolve.
Phase for 1, evolve, see what you get. I think that's always still a random thing first. Come on.
That's pretty 3. Good.
Yeah, sub the big guy. So we can expect him to kill the gang boss here to prevent the full value from the master. So then the weapon charge should be gone and Pit Snake starts to do things.
Yeah.
could just be full smork. Yep. So 7 puts us down to 6. Okie dokie, that's quite the draw.
Don't want it to be. If we use our weapon, it's probably got to be on the 1/1 here. Do you want to? I think we kind of need the shadow strike.
I think you burgle. Let's start with burgle because it feels like right. We're going to juggler.
Okay, that's good. Do we want an earth ellie here?
Pretty huge. Bump, bump. So that makes the hex super awkward for him. Hmm. So, yeah, that's got to be more chance to win, right? Yeah, I think 4/5 into 4/3. 4/5 into 3/4, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then Earth Ellie. Imgang into the 1/1 and an Earth Ellie, yeah. I think that's fine.
Sorry, positioning's up. Do you want to push this weapon into the face?
I don't think
we
do that.
Or you want to save for a totem, right?
No,
just save it for a totem. Fine. We're not in the aggro. We're not in the spot where we can close out the game.
It's okay. So what I was thinking before we burgled there was, what if we just strike the 3/4, face tank the 1/1, and then go from there? Mm-hmm. I mean, obviously this is great for him, but it also means that reach isn't going into our face.
Yep.
All right, so I think that's still good to stabilize, and Shadow Strike super premium here. We have good trades. Yeah, it's looking up.
Do you want to start with Flame Juggler's looking pretty good this turn. Do you want to start with a swash? Wait, so we've got, hold on.
So,
I'm jumping ahead.
Yeah,
Shadow damage. Strike cleans up the 5/5 really easily.
Which means we'll have 3 mana, which means if we then juggle, both targets are pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
We probably want a pit snake, so there's no room for the burglar. So Shadow Strike to 5/5 happens. And then I think it's probably better to juggler first, because both are pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you can put down a pit snake as well. Yeah,
okay,
let's put down a pit snake.
How do you want to do this trade?
I think it's just the 1/1 into the 4/1, 4/2 into the 2/3 gangboss phase. It's a bit awkward. Maybe we should have taken a good trade first. Yeah. Maybe we should, maybe we shouldn't. So if we had, what would he have sacked though? We would have put the 4/2 into the 4/1 and double traded. Bolvar. As to hex a snake, I guess he's snake. Just really upset that he didn't do that when we had the thing up.
Start with a swash here.
So we're going to be hexing and most likely knighting. So yeah, swash is okay.
That's a good card.
Yeah.
Don't think we draw anything here. Save that for next turn.
Yeah.
I
think we put the knight on the far left, hex the 4/7, clear his boards, and it's irrelevant how you do it. Just bump, 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 and then priestess.
Do you want to use the weapon? So wait, clearing his board. Do you want to use the weapon here and push 2 extra to the face?
For some reason, I thought we needed everything. Yeah, I'd use the weapon and push the 2 extra face. For some reason, I thought we needed everything to kill. But yeah, just ignore me. All right. So yeah, now we lose an Impify AoEs, but I think getting the 2 power down is still relevant. So.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
There we go.
That means we're not adept to Frost Shock. Rocketeer.
Man, we get a 0/1 taunt on the board, and we didn't even need to play a Yogg-Saron to get it.
So we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What's in that deck? We have Dwarf. You want to Ancestral Knowledge for Dwarf?
Yep, I want to do that first. All right. That's good. It's good enough. assassinate, dagger, push everything into the face.
Yeah, I think the safer line is the Cult Master and draw. Well, that depends what you mean with safe. I think this gives him one turn, so assassinate all face is good.
Yeah.
It's when you see games like this, you just realize what a clown fiesta Hearthstone has become. Like, he's had a Bolvar, we have an Imgang Plus. There's no Warlock or Paladin even in the game.
Oh, man. Yeah, going on what you said with, like, what's the safe play there, I think if we had more reach in the deck, like, we'd be more willing to trade in that board into the Kraken there, like, just to, because otherwise, like, if we do play the Cult Master, he has some sort of AoE, like an LE Destruction. I think we just get more turns, give him, I think, a better chance of winning.
I think this puts you in a better spot regardless, because you give him one turn for one out, and that is AoE, so that's fine. Yeah, good to keep going. Holy shit, what a start, though.
Yeah.
Spirit Claw, super good against our deck. Lots and lots of, like, pesky one health minions for us, and then that Spirit Claw does so much stuff.
You ready to go on to the next
one? Yeah, you can keep going. Qzon 619, thanks so much for subbing, man. Appreciate that. Welcome to the stream. Hey, Solemn Silence, thank you. Kappa Pride's back at you. Yeah, Bolvar becomes bigger. It's kind of a ghoul, but it works from your hand, and it's only friendlies, right? So whenever a friendly dies, you get +1 damage on the Bolvar, and it starts out as a Mogushan. Ooh, Clutch Burgles? Yes, the Burgles were good. The Hex on the Snake, though, Craigasm, yeah.
Alright, drop it all. Look for that one.
Definitely. Another Shaman. Yeah, man, I'm telling you. I think Shaman's number one right now. It's pretty sick how good it is. In addition to your Clown Fiesta comment, your Rogue was more overloaded than the Shaman. I like the Burglar here to test the waters, see if he's got it.
Yeah, see if he's got that weapon. I'll take it.
One mana hand. Got the engineer.
Yeah, it's
That's okay. This is why we have to draft double burgle, right? Just to make sure we have enough steam. Ooh.
I like double ones here. That's my initial thought.
So Maelstrom Portal wins him the game on the spot then, right? Well, no, because we have the roll. Yeah.
Yeah.
So double ones are definitely not bad here.
Yeah. So if the Young Priestess lands on the Pit Snake, Maelstrom Portal is fine. We potentially Earthshock that one and drop a Novice to protect the Pit Snake on the next turn.
So it's a coin flip followed by him having Maelstrom, yes or no. So yeah, I think Priestess Pit Snake's fine for that reason. Yep,
yeah. Good. Let's see. Okay, positioning here. Priestess middle, Pit Snake left.
Sure. Yep. You never need a buff on the Pit Snake, so... Do you think Arena's getting a bit harder to control since of the Cloud Fiesta game you just had? I feel like that's more the upper end. People are always, and obviously it's my fault for even mentioning it, but coin X, looks like an X, yeah.
So he's an Earthshock target?
Yeah, not bad. Could also just dagger, depending on how much we need. So like to control Arena, like if you just have a good early game, that's like, just the most important thing, just having a good early game. I think I like the juggler here. If it lands, we trade the 1-1. If it misses, we Urchuk.
Yeah, right. Sounds good.
I think Urchuk's pretty good to keep, so. Yep, shuck it up. Alright, so he burned coin and he's overloaded, so he's playing a 2-mana card here. Priestess is going to get wrecked. Yeah, that could be a relevant buff if he plays a 3-2 here. Nope.
I mean, I guess we're a little bit more... way. Okay, so I mean...
okay with that.
That, I mean...
So I think because you're probably using Shadow Strike next turn... You should probably DID the 1-2, kill the totem with the 2-3 and push the 3 face and just get the 4-4 body developed.
Yep.
Alright. It's always like...
There is a thought though, right, with this deck where we like we really want that effect trading around with minions. Like we're not a deck that is going to be all the, like necessarily very effective, you know, with the more aggressive DID instead of the more controlling DID.
Yeah, he is pretty low already because he is using his life as a resource. Yep. So I think getting the minion developed is good.
Novice first?
Yeah, I think we're always shadow striking, so novice first. All right, strike it up, six phase. I've definitely met a lot of these aggressive rogues the past 3 days. It's the ones I lose to if I'm building a really controlly deck. You're in trouble now. You're in trouble now.
So we can. Could one option is Senshin Dagger, put him down to 3?
Well, all our things go face, right? There's no way we're trading into this.
Yep.
So it's indeed either Senshin Dagger or Peddler. With the dagger, you get 2 additional damage over 2 turns. With the Peddler, you allow yourself to play a 4 and a 3 next turn. I think Senshin Dagger is better.
Yeah.
Yep. Getting the damage in there.
We're also fairly likely to top deck a 4 with this deck, right?
Yep. Yeah, lots of 4s, I think. 7 or 8. The Burgle Rogue has been named Pickpocket Rogue. we like the Pickpocket Rogue. It's Hitman Shady. What's up, first of all?
I remember when priests used to steal things.
They still do. They still do.
Just not as good.
Yeah, it's funny how that shifted around, where Druid became the Beast class and Rogue became the Thief class.
Yeah.
Play around MCT. I think if you play around MCT here, there's more chance he stabilizes by you not developing.
Yeah.
GG.
Looks good. We didn't have Ancestral Healing.
Nope.
Wait, is that one of the ones that got removed, right?
That could very well be. That's something I should do my best to, like, take a look at that list again.
Yeah, it's the refill and give taunt, 0 mana. I'm pretty sure that one got removed because Blizzard's smarter than me and when it comes to Arena, because I wouldn't have removed it.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like they're just removing the lowest win rate card. I'm good to queue again, by the way. They're removing the lowest win rate cards. I don't know. Some of them are kind of awkward. I think the big one, because I mean, you can argue Cobra Shot, you can argue Mark of the Wild, but Mark of Nature. I think the big one is the Wind Speaker, right?
Yeah, especially over Wind Fury.
Yeah. So their logic for that is that the cards were pretty close in win rate, which means that too many people draft Wind Speaker and don't know how to use it. Because there's no way that Wind Fury is anywhere close to Wind Speaker, so people just use the card wrong, and that's why it's kind of had a bad stat.
So keeping the 1 and the 2.
Keeping the 1 and the 2. I don't hate full keep, but I think we ditch the Shadow Strike to look for Shredder. Just curve out like a bounce.
Coining the Senshin into Cult Master might work for us, yeah. Maybe.
Depending on what lives.
Yeah.
Not much. I'm okay with Swashburglar. I think preserving coin's a good thing.
Just another option. Let's see what we get. We have a 1 dragon in the deck, correct?
We have a 2/6, yep. That's correct.
I had, let's see, the deck that ended my last run played, I want to say, 1 Nether Spite Historian and 3 of these Nightbane Templars. All of them got activated.
Oh wow!
It was not a fun experience.
I like the dagger to 1/1 here.
Yeah,
yeah. I think like Thespian sets you up for Paladin things.
Yep. So dagger, plan to coin 4s next turn.
Yeah, dagger kill the 1/1. Satcake asked what kind of wristband I use. So the this is just the brace, and this is custom made in hospital. This isn't anything special. Like, it's not a brand or anything. So Yuki. I like the Shredder here. I think Sanji's a bit, you know, more vulnerable to him going Silver Moon Portal on the 2-3.
Yeah, Silver Moon, Seal of Champions, Blessing of Kings, all seem to hurt the Senshin more, so let's get the Shredder down.
So this is why we didn't want to play the Thespian last time. That would have been pretty awkward.
Okay, good for us.
Fairly good. I hope you
like my dagger target, we like that.
Yeah, we're stabilizing, this is good. Senjin, kill the 2-3, stab the 1-1, looking good.
Yep.
Yeah. So you can really feel it, guys, here, that this is kind of the premise of our deck, right? Where we drafted less 2-drops with the aim of coining 4-drops and thus being more card efficient than our opponent, but definitely starting a little bit slower, so it's kind of a scary start, but then once you stabilize, you're going to have more cards than your opponent, which really puts you in a nice position. Okay.
Sap can get rid of a
Avenged minion.
Yeah. So we could dagger into the 1-1. Sap the avenged target. Start dealing with the board. That's all we can do with that, though.
We don't want to get the Argent back in his hand, though. Like, under no circumstance.
Yeah. So we could run into the protector first. If the recruit gets a buff, then we do something besides sap. It's an option.
I think you put the Senjin into the 2-2 and go from there, and I think it sounds weird, but it's probably a decent start. Alright, let's get down, that's fine.
Okay.
Get down. So he's going to hero power and free kill that with the 3-3.
We could just disguise it.
Yeah, that's definitely one option. Dagger to 1-1, 2-3. That's good. Yeah,
I like stealth minion with the DID in.
I like just the stealth here. Yeah, it's good. I think our health should be able to take it in the long run. So.
Yeah.
So if we had dagger to 1-1 first, and Avenge would have landed on the 2-2, that would have been bad. So I think it was an okay start. Does not go for the buff. That's fine. Oh, he goes for the clear.
He's going to run the 3-3 in then?
Yeah, I think you definitely run the 3-3 in if you're him. I don't think you want to have...
No, he's making his board smaller, which is good for us.
Yep. Yeah, if you're being aggressive, guys, you definitely want a wider board. And as, you know, against Rogue's pretty good at dealing with one.
Yeah, one thing. So it's looking like the Senshin can probably go into this Cellar Spider. Might want to sap the snowball.
Yeah, it's definitely not terrible to take the trades with the 3-3 and the 3-3 either.
For sapping, we can develop. If we develop double twos, we're going to be really weak to a concentration. We could just get the DID out this next turn with the sap play. We'll see what we draw off the top. That might change things. I'm just trying to think a little bit ahead here. Okay, so
pretty sure we're sapping the 2-6, right?
Yeah, we could DID the Senjin and dagger into the snowball to remove it that way. That is an option for us that allows us to.
I don't like it though, because then he, like, we have sap and assassinate. I feel this is the ideal moment to use it.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that allows him a lot of options, so I'm pretty sure I want to sap the 2-6.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm okay starting with that. So
it doesn't feel like we need draw. Like, we could just play the Colt. It's weak to Consecration, but he can't really develop much into the board after it. Like, if he did top deck it, go into the 1/3.
I kind of want to just exchange 3/3s and play a 4/4 here. I think it's fine.
Do you want to do Thespian and not Novice?
No, so just Dwarf. Just kill the 3/3 and Dwarf. I feel like that's nice and safe and like responsible here, because
and with us picking up the Assassinate, him dropping a big buff like a Blessing of Kings, this feels a lot. It feels a lot safer. Just leave. There's that.
Nice. Yeah, perfect. So I feel if you Thespian here, you give up your Thespian to the Justice in the 1/3. Yep. So I think the 4/4 body just was your only play.
Assassinate here?
Assassinating the 5/9 and trading the 1/3, yeah, definitely. We can talk about the merits of 2/3, 3/2.
I mean...
So the upside of the Juggler is you can double trade into the 2/6 and then Thespian to lock him out. The upside of the Thespian is you have one more reach and you can utilize a Flame Juggler's bump somewhere.
And we protect the DID potentially from a weapon, our charge. The Flame Juggler also potentially can land on the Snowbolt next turn, and then that dagger will, the dagger would be able to finish off the Snowbolt with the DID on board.
I kind of like the Juggler here. I think preserving the talent, especially with the Cult Master, is going to be huge.
Yep.
Because we have a guaranteed line if he drops the 2/6, right? It's double bump.
Yep.
And then Thespian, so are you okay with that? Yeah, it's a close call, and I don't fault anyone for playing Thespian here. But I really like preserving the taunt when we don't need to play it yet. Because now we're just sitting, waiting for our burglars as well.
And then, you know, mentioning, you know, the top deck Consecration, we do get to keep something on the board with this play.
Yep. It shouldn't be something that he wants to play, but yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, I hope you are having a good time. If you are and you are new to the channel, feel free to hit the follow button. It's very much appreciated. Same goes out for Isherwood. If one of the moderators can put his Twitch in the chat, he's also an arena streamer. One of the only people to complete the 110. I'm not sure if you actually like to be known for that or.
Oh, yeah, no, I mean, old. It's a selling point. I gotta go with it.
Gotta go with it, right? Okay,
it's
cool.
It's too good to pass up, right?
Too good to pass, yeah. It's sometimes it's okay to be that guy.
It's yeah, you know, and it's one of those things. It's helped me out. Sometimes, like, when I'm having really bad streaks, like I am right now, I just gotta say, like, you know what? I got the 110 ton. Yeah. Like, I've gotta be a good player, right?
I'm actually gonna take 1 second issue, so.
All right, sounds
BRB.
Good. All right, chat, you got any questions for me? You've got my full attention. How's it going, everybody? Hey, who's that Isherwood guy? Looks pretty cool. Give him a follow there. It's that guy, the 110 guy. I do not sing. However, if anybody is going to donate for a song request, I would suggest Obey the Beard. Why is Soraka the worst support in League? Because Sona is better. I have now switched. I have discarded my Soraka ways. I have picked up the harpsichord of justice, moved on to Sona. Do you rather fight a hunt? That is a boring question. Next, how about them A's? Best corn dog you've ever had? They're all delicious. I love all corn dogs equally. Oh yeah, Wadi, I'm all about Sona. I need to try Nami for sure, and I've been watching the Worlds. I'm a really new player, but Nami is expensive when it comes to IP, so I have not had the chance to try out Nami. Was 110? It takes a lot of talking. Somebody in chat will say it. I did 100 wins and 10 arena runs in a row. That's the short of it. But there's a bunch of silly little rules. Yep, that is true, Savage Al. Mini corn dogs and regular size corn dogs are both delicious. What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow? I am not quite sure. I'll give you a guess what my favorite color is, though. Or what my two favorite colors are. Do I have any Hearthstone exercises you recommend to practice that you can be done to get better? Yep, good to go. The simplest, Beasthaven, given the limited time, watch people play the game and just get as much practice as you can in yourself. But I think a really good thing to do when watching streams is just try to think of the play that you would do and compare it to what the person does and see if your play is better or their play is better, or if, you know, just analyze the game while you're watching. I think that's really helpful to improving. Where do I stream? Do I stream? Yes, I do, Data Pusher. My schedule is pretty consistent. Usually start at noon Pacific Standard Time, go 6 to 8 hours. All right, pretty limited on threes. You like keeping the Harvest Golem?
Yeah, Golem and Priestess for me. There's going to be some mm-hmms and mm-mm. Because I'm going to be eating, so.
Sounds good. All right. So we're good with Priestess and Golem?
Mm-hmm. All right. It's our one and only Dragon PokeChamp.
All right. Can an opponent please not play a one drop? That'd be most excellent. Awesome. Liking this so far. Drop the young Priestess?
Yep. Looks good. Was he holding the claws? I think you always play that on one, but
yeah.
People are terrified of ooze.
Unless you just got hit with an ooze and you're just and you're having a moment of reflection. Do you still play the claws on one? I think I like coining the Harvest Golem. He seems to bump into the Priestess, allows us to pit Snake and Dagger next turn.
Yeah, so we could also engineer a way where Pit Snake goes into the 7/7.
Mm-hmm.
So I think Coin Harvest here is fine. Yeah. Still gonna need to get lucky here. He's gonna need to like Tuskar and Whiff, or just Totem, or play a 3/2 or whatever.
Only a matter of time before Tuskar's not guaranteed. Isn't gonna be guaranteed a Whiff. It could still get a Taunt Totem, which would have been good in this circumstance. Why do I even talk?
what the fuck, man? Yeah, Pit Snake has to come out, so just bump Dagger to 2/1, Pit Snake. I feel with the
does Pit Snake need to come out?
So let's see what he does, right? Pit Snake.
Like if he plays a 7/7, right? We bump into the Tuskar, we drop a Shredder, and we have Assassinate, or we've got Torn and Pit Snake on the next turn. I don't think Pit Snake needs to come out here. We could just drop a Torn even the next turn if we want to, or...
So we're taking 3 face and our Harvest Golem's taking 3 damage. What can you do to make us regret not playing Pit Snake here? You can play Ascension Shieldmaster. That starts to pile on. I think you just played a Pit Snake. I think that you're totally right that there's tons of cases where it's fine. But I feel with our hand, we're equipped to deal with what he throws at us. So we just play around the Taunt here and make him trade a 3/2 into a 2/1. Because that's a trade we'll take, right?
Hmm?
So, but yeah, I totally share the sentiment that wasn't forced. But I feel like there's tons of ways where he can get really far ahead if we don't.
I like the Shredder here.
Yep, Shredder. I don't like preemptively hitting with either. I think two
faces. Yeah, yeah.
I think if he rolls Heal Totem, you still have your 2/4. And especially with only one dagger charge. Shady, why do you not play Pit Snake? Doesn't it bait the Tuskar? You mean on turn two? Please, when you're suggesting a player, you're asking something, please include the turn Beast Haven. Makes it easier for me to reply.
I think I'd like the Assassinate here on the Fin Creeper.
Yeah, judging how the board looks.
Yeah, it's just leaving up that teacher for one more turn just feels uncomfortable.
Yeah, it's just like we don't deal with the Fen Creeper in a very good way here. So I'd use the face. So.
Yep. That's good. Face best tool.
Oh, we win that joust easy.
Oh, a lot of ones. So this looks like...
This looks like pain. Lots of pain. This looks like face into the thing and Tarn.
Yeah, it seems alright.
Yeah, alright, let's do that. A little bit of feels bad. There's no way the golem goes in, right? Yeah,
no way. No.
Just makes Maelstrom Portal better and shit. So, sorry for that, guys. I'm gonna try not to tap the plate too often. I know that sounds pretty loud because the mic's here. I'm actually just put the mic a bit away. There we go. So this should still be fine, right, guys? But then you're not, like, right next to the plate. We must
cleanse the sun well. That's... Okay, it's perhaps the best totem for us.
So 2/2 and dragon into the 6/5, no matter what. Because even if we buck, we'd still want to take down the 3/2. So.
We could disguise the young priestess.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the shattered dies to the golem and face kills the scarab, because I think there's more beast synergy these days than totem synergy.
In shaman itself? Not really.
Well, because right. Menagerie things, right?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, Menagerie. Yeah.
So 2/4 yeah, plus, 3/2 plus, face into 1/1.
Plus Scarab's really scary for Brubach.
Priestess first, then Stealth, then Echoing Ooze. Because we want the Ooze to split after it gets buffed. Yep. No, I think that, sure, he can have Totem Synergy on the board, but I think that's... From what we're looking at here, it's Totem Carver, Thunderbluff Valiant, that's kind of it. Whereas, there's actually kind of an awkward moment where he plays Menagerie Magician, he gets a 3/3, it's like, especially if he adds a Dragon or a Murloc.
GG. Seemed like an early concede, but... Mm-hmm. He knows his deck.
That definitely right, seemed preemptive, yeah. That definitely seemed preemptive.
Hey, you, I'm not one to, you know...
I got my own sorry, what did you say?
I'm not one to be against, like, an early concede, but you really want to look through your decks and make sure you don't have any Discover or any of those, like, sort of swashburglar, you know, shenanigans in your deck, because, like, if you just look through it and say, like, oh, I don't have an AoE, just, you know, make sure, you know, when you're playing the game, like, you know, you don't always want to drop those early concedes. Keep the Young Priestess?
Yep. I got my own says we skipped the Twilight Guardian synergy. The dragon was not played. It came from a Shredder. So there was no weight above the dragon.
double priestess on turn two?
Yeah, I think that's better. Yep. Nope. Absolutely terrible issue. What the fuck? I guess it has to be Priestess Snake. Not always. So if we double Priestess, it's pretty awkward for him, right?
Yeah, the Snake makes it more reliable to drop an Illusionist on the following turn, right?
So if we double Priestess here, it's fairly likely that he'll ping one Priestess, kill the other. Which means then we'll dagger down the thing, play Snake, get the Snake buffed.
I like that.
That's pretty good, actually, yeah. Let's double Priestess. That seems good.
And then if he plays removal on a Priestess, then, you know, the other Priestess trades, and that's also fine.
Yep. Exactly. But I think Hero Power to Priestess is, like, a default play for Mage here. I don't think he's going to want to do anything else. Yeah, Hero Power to Priestess, that's much better. Holy shit! Holy shit! I thought he was going to go face as well. Yeah, we will take that donation. Dagger and Pit Snake. Wow. So he must have like Argent Horse Rider or something, right? Assuming that he didn't just throw the game there.
Yeah. Options. I think the two lines we want to consider is the Thespian and a redagger play, or just we drop the Illusionist.
I think we'd
let go of the Young Priestess here because Water Ellie is always going to be a frustrating thing to deal with.
Well, I mean, if you Thespian, it's not like Water Ellie becomes good, right? Because he can't remove and play a 4. If he's got removal for the Thespian, he's got removal for the Pit Snake. I think it's all about flexibility for next turn. So next turn we just drop the Silver Hand. Honestly, I just play Thespian here. And then hit his face, redagger. I think you've got a coin flip. If you win the coin flip, he's in a pretty bad spot.
Any thought to hitting that prong?
I thought about it, but I think because we're redaggering, it's all good. We can just go in next turn. And potentially we don't lose health because we Illusionist. So. I think that curve-wise, it's okay to play Illusionist here, but you've got Silverhand anyway. Mm-hmm. So I think going for the coin flip here, yeah, awesome. And now he's just getting super punished for not respecting the Priestess and pinging it. Little Batman. That's correct, Toaster guy. Water Ally needs to deal damage to freeze you. So if you violate the Illusionist, you don't get frozen. I'd assume so. I've never tried, but I'd assume so.
This is Silverhand Knight, mainly just for flexibility on the next turn, right?
I agree. Silverhand Knight, and I'd even consider using the face, but I think because of Burgle, we probably decide against it. Because we're probably going to draw more cards and might need to charge.
Yep. We're pretty happy with the Young Priestess hitting there. Young Priestess has been landed some good rolls.
Beast Haven asks, why was it so bad for him to ping face? If he pings one Priestess and kills the other Priestess, he then always has the option to ping off the second Priestess whenever he wants Beast Haven. Whereas now he's like, for instance, this is pretty much the best example. Priestess would have died here if he had pinged her. But now instead, he'll have to commit another Hero Power to get that to work.
So if we do the Swashburglar line, we could go Swash, Illusionist, Redagger. I think I'm fine with a Burgle an illusionist here? Oh. Okay, he wants to ping next turn, right?
So, coin has been used. He coined out a bone guard.
Mm-hmm.
I don't play around Blizzard, so I'd play Burglar here, see what we get, and then probably just Flame Juggler Illusionist go in, use the Burgle next turn. Yeah.
Okay, we just need a secret from that Burgle. Okay, so Flame Juggler?
Yeah, Flame Juggler far right will do, and then Illusionist far right again.
So if that hits the Spider Tank, do you want to use... I want to use our face and the 2-2?
Face definitely, and then face for 4 with the other guy. I think using the 2-2 is fine. It puts the pressure on him of having to hero power again.
Yeah. Definitely don't want to use... I like keeping this Silverhand Knight a little bit healthier, a little bit out of Flamestrike range.
For sure. I still respect Flamestrike. I just don't think you can respect Blizzard and beat Portal, so it's an automatic no play around.
There goes our easy play around Flamestrike. you want to start with a Burgle here?
Mm-hmm. And we just get lethal and kill him.
Let's see here. We've 10, got 8, 11, 9, 10.
12. Yep, that's it. GG. My monk stats are always the same, guys. My monk stats are legendary, so we don't touch them. No synergy? Yeah. I'd rather just kill him.
BM synergizes really well with Mage.
I don't know. Like I've said multiple times, it really doesn't bother me. Probably one of the only people right now, but I really don't mind it. Because, I mean, it's because I don't think Mage is the strongest.
Drop the double fives. Do we want to look for a one and drop a two here?
I just keep Juggler, yeah. I think yeah. I'd rather look for a good one, and I want to coin fours most likely, so...
Yeah, it's like coining the twos feels like it can lead to a bad situation for us around turn three or turn four.
I mean, if we get a really good curve for it, I'll do it, but... maybe not. I think it's just Priestess, though. I think we want to save that flexibility.
Okay.
Because, I mean, against a lot of 2-drops, it won't matter.
If we had a 3, I would really like coining the ones here.
Mm-hmm. I like what the snake does with the Ascension, if we put a bind on, so... I think it's Flame Juggler and probably hit his face. I think we take the buff. Yep, let's hit the face.
Coin Sinjin looks pretty decent here.
So True Silver is bad, but other than that, it's fine. So yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we still get to keep the board.
Yep. Yeah, I think in all cases it's Sinjin. It's just thinking about what could go wrong.
Blessing of Kings, but I mean, we can't really.
Yeah.
We could drop the pit. Like Pit Snake is. Yeah. We're gonna be weak to other things.
If you Pit Snake, you give up the Pit Snake to an Acolyte. So I don't like that. He just holds the Kings then. Yeah, Kings is terrifying. Silver Moon Portal's okay.
Just we've got the Peddler combos.
We could definitely opt to just stock.
It might not be the right thing, but I really want to do it.
I feel like so you definitely burgle this turn, and then you can see whether you want to add the swash or play the pit snake.
Yeah.
Mmm, juicy. So, we should just play a pit snake to delete his five, shouldn't we?
We have the Oldemon to delete his five.
But then you can't play Peddler on curve. Yeah, I think it's 100% pit snake here and just double trade. I don't think you can really make sense to not developing pit snake behind a taunt into his five.
Yeah. Fine, I guess so.
This boring ass dude didn't want to triple discount. What the fuck? No, Bati is no longer giving points. You cannot redo for an undetermined amount of time. All right. What's a nice English word for that, Isherwood? Indefinite. Or?
You're asking an American for vocabulary. That's not going to work well for you.
Yeah. No, motherfucker. Anything but that one.
I don't know. I think I like Swashburglar, Pit Snake, Dagger here.
Yeah, we're not leaving that up. So
yeah,
Swashburglar.
Again, I just want to get all these cards in. All right.
That's pretty unplayable. Yep, let's take it out.
Put this apple on your head.
No.
Come on, Bit Snake. I know you're done a feat, but show me some footwork. Let's go. Coin flip for the game. This guy is too good at the game.
Dagger, move the taunt.
Mm-hmm.
So, if we play that Peddler, the main thing we're looking at is this Oldemon, which becomes two, which means we can go Silverhand Knight and Oldemon next turn. You could do Shredder.
I like the Peddler because it sets up Enter the Colosseum as well next turn, where mm-hmm. he might just run by this and then we Colosseum. Boom.
Sounds good.
Yep. You can even go for the super dirty line of enter the Colosseum, then shrink his guy and kill it for free. Get paladins, bitch! Bam!
Oh, looks like it.
Marta, thank you so much for the host. Welcome, Marta boys.
Face's place.
Oh, we're gonna need some good BM here, sure. This is necessary.
Let's start with our greetings. Pleasure is mine.
Right. Enter the Colosseum.
I mean, we should thank him also for his cards.
Oh yeah, okay. That's important.
I mean, it's the polite thing to do.
Do we even shrink it?
I don't think so. Like, it's such a valuable card.
You do develop the body and you keep your guy healthier, though.
We have an assassinate also to deal with anything big. I'm fine with using it.
Yeah, I think you shrink his guy in trade. I think it's just to put the thing on the board. Rogue with AoE, yep.
We can get a one mana.
Alright, I'm fine keeping that for flex. Yep.
I think it's probably better to be rewind the old one. It's probably going to be the better target.
It's probably better. Gee, that one health totally mattered, man. So good.
Kill the 3-2, Silverhand, Dagger the 1-1, pull it back, just to take no chance.
Yep, looks good.
That looks good. Oh, the man's pretty decent card. He's like, alright man, I'm gonna have to throw this big dude at him. I'm like, nope. No big dudes allowed, sorry.
He could just crack in the 4-4 and say, hey.
Yeah.
Mini Kraken.
What's the most annoying thing if he plays Stand Against Darkness, spreads out like that? Then we burgle a consecration. Yeah, I guess nothing's bad.
Oh, I didn't win the bomb.
Oh man, Anti-Keeper of Oldham on tag. Do you want to burgle here?
Yep. Yoink. Pickpocket Rogue.
Oh my god.
Kill the Lobber with the 4-4.
So this Solemn's gonna go down to 3, that's not enough, right?
Well, the dagger goes into the 1-1, so it's killing 2-3. Yeah, it's gonna be 3.
So it's alright, we just kill the 3-3, kill the 1-1, Shredder a mini-bot. Guess if we have to, we'll play this premium. We'll just go back to GBG. Turn 4, Shredder mini-bot. Oh, Shredder not in the middle! I think we'll live. That's fine.
We'll see.
This Paladin's getting paladonked, yeah. It's vengeance for all these seasons where Paladin was good. It was like, now you will die.
It looks like 4-1 of the 4-4, probably get a vigil off.
Yup. Ruined, yeah. Easiest concede now. Can't win anymore.
Okay. Shredder into the 4-4. It's gonna make the vigil 3. Like, we just want to drop. Like, we don't want to really be playing anything.
I think 4-1 into the 4-4 and vigil, okay.
Alright.
Sure, we're at the point where we almost have enough mana. That's a decent minion. Oh my god.
Oh, we can get a dragon from the swashbuckler.
Yeah.
Ready for it?
I'll take a Tyrion, but yeah, sure. Take a constellation dragon.
You
Tyrion's
know,
okay. Tyrion. Never dragon, man. Never lucky.
Yeah, I know. I just wanted a 5/5 each.
You want to play novice? Easy. You want to play into MCT now to get it over?
Oh yeah, totally. So I mean, I think at this point it's only fair that you play into MCT.
Yeah. I think you need to, so he can't like Hungry Dragon steal your Tyrion next turn. So.
So novice.
Yeah.
And then.
Just play the 2/6 here. I think. Yep, yeah. That's fine.
I wanna.
But you guys never ask for your cards? No wonder, no wonder. That's really my one key to infinite, guys. When playing an RNG card, make sure you ask the game what you want, otherwise it doesn't know, right? All right, Tyrion, I guess. You're talking to the man that once burgled 2 Tyrions. It's like, yoink. Oh my god, I kind of want to just sap Tyrion and watch him concede.
That seems good.
Yeah, let's do it. Sap Tyrion. I guess we just free kill with the 2/6 just in case he's got the tech. Ta 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 ta.
Oh man, misplay. We didn't get an attack with our Watchmen.
That's bad. You could summon Tyrions by calling for them. Tyrion and I go way back, guys.
No! We wasted the sap. He's getting the Ashbringer.
Okay. Tyrion becomes 12.
Stop it, stop it. He's already dead, Bible Thump. Oh my god. At this point, you've played more Paladin cards than Rogue cards. Probably. Tyrion again? Man, I'd rather get a rag, Kappa. Well, I can't burgle a rag, unfortunately.
Yeah.
There's no Tyrion in either our deck. I think. And there's two Tyrians on the board. Clown Fiesta game confirmed.
Assassinate seems decent. I mean, we don't have lethals, right?
Yeah, I think you just assassinate the Tyrian. Throw
Cult one. Master, 2 1-1s in.
So assassinate the Tyrian. Let's start with that. Just want to look at what the Blessed Champion does here. You have to go in for 12. No, you still have 2-turn lethal with the Cult Master. It's fine. Yep. Cult Master, truthful. Thank you. Oh, sorry, man. Okay. I'm sorry you have to go through this. Alright. Shady has a Tyrian. He's mastered every aspect of his game.
Alright, I need to take a short break.
Yeah, and go for it, man. Go
back,
for it.
Back momentarily.
But it was such a desperate move. Yeah, at that point, he just threw cards on the board because stuff happened, right? That's the point where you just throw cards on the board and say, I don't want to play anymore. But I don't like conceding, so I'm going to put cards on the board. So that's really him. And you can't really blame him there. You can't really blame him. How do you get to this board? Swashburglar, swashburglar, burgle, burgle. Yoink, 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 yoink. Steal all the things. All right. So guys, we've got 1 or 2 minutes. Let's make it count. Cap pride. If you guys have any questions, obviously, feel free to shoot. Isherwood. Well, I know Isherwood's from America, but I think you need something more specific. Does anyone know more specific where Isherwood's from? I still have a hard time being a little bit more specific. It's like, yes, that continent. Well, I suppose the northern part of that continent. Oh, man. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Shady, when you think about it, Hearthstone streams are like live-action Yu-Gi-Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Arizona. Arizona, guys. There we go. Why no tank top today? Because Sunday, we dress a little bit more formal. Sunday, we put on our shirt and tie. Sometimes no tie, depending on what shirt I'm wearing. Some shirts. Yeah. Hey, welcome back.
Back at QNN.
He's from the woods of Isher, obviously. Hey Shady, I sent you an application for co-ops. I'm afraid it got wrecked by your spam filter. Maybe I just haven't replied yet. Valera versus Geras. Depends when you sent it.
Keep it on.
What a hand. Yeah, we keep it on. Looks like burglar into either Buccaneer or Harvest Golem and then Priestess Reflex.
Very likely to draw 4 in this deck.
Shady, have you ever said it's time to duel right before you queue in? Well, this wasn't right before we queued in, so no. All right.
Oh, swash?
Yeah. Swash. Ah.
Hey, maybe a Thrill Peddler will make into a playable card.
We'll counter his unleash the taunts with our unleash the taunts. Like that.
Buck Coin Dagger?
Absolutely. Ghoul. What does Ghoul do? Ghoul's annoying. Damn it, Ghoul, yeah. Why are you such a good card?
But, I mean...
Yeah, it's the best play. It's the best play. Yeah. Just making sure. There's no real good player on Ghoul here. It's going well, Pixel. Thank you for asking. If you are a newer player, is it better to save up for Arena or just buy packs with the money. That totally depends on what your goal is, Riz. If your goal is on not playing too much Arena and just getting your packs for Constructed, playing Constructed, then I would advise you to stay away from Arena, seeing as you really need to put in a little bit of dedication and effort to get your money's worth, right? You can't just like do nothing and expect to get 150 gold back. But if you want to play Arena, right, it's something you enjoy doing, then it's definitely worth doing it. But I wouldn't put yourself through the trouble of just, you know, like, ugh, I gotta play Arena. Curious as to what you like, Hirisha.
I'm looking. I think I like removing the Fierce Monkey with the Buck and the Dagger.
I really like going in with the face and then just re-daggering, killing it with the Buck and dropping the Pit Snake. I think that makes it so that if he spreads, you've got the weapon in the 1-1. If he plays a fat guy, you've got Pit Snake.
Yeah, you're... Yep, and Harvest Golem is going to give you the same power on the board as the weapon. I like it. Yeah,
seems good. Yeah, this is just one of those kind of greedy optimal plays, but this is why Pit Snake's so good when you're playing against the non-mage or rogue or whatever. Yeah, so he has to go out of his way here. Obviously, that's a great answer, right? But the fact that he has to skip is like,
ugh. Yeah.
He would have much rather slammed that 4-drop here. So. Man, I really don't want to throw my priestess into the grinder.
I don't want to either. Do you want to drop an illusionist? It's more power on the board.
So what the priestess does do is it protects your 1-1, which does give you 3 additional reach on top of the illusionists rather than just 2. Don't think you need it. Yeah, I think just illusionist 1-face is fine.
And Fool's Bane would always do Fool's Bane things, yeah. With no matter what we did.
Yeah, I don't think it's worth to Bane for him here. I think if he's got 4, he just kills the 1, drops the 4.
Well, he can run the 1 damage weapon in, play Fool's Bane, use that to remove the Illusionist, and then you'd have 3 charges on it.
But I mean, I think you'd rather develop this turn and then next turn Bane. I'm not sure whether that's right, though. I wouldn't feel very tempted to Bane in this situation. If I had a 4-drop, that is.
Alright, weapon into the Crusher, Illusionist, and then Silverhand Knight is my first, or Silverhand Regent, it's my first thing I see. Gives us the most power.
Yeah, just looking at what he plays. So I want to prepare for Obsidian as well. I think it's fine to get the Silverhand out. Yep. Phase goes in first, of course. I mean, I obviously love Arena, so for me, Arena is the main game mode. I don't look at Arena as a means to an end. I look at, you know, Arena as the end. I do love getting better at the game and I enjoy it, but a lot of people look at Arena as a way to farm cards. And going in with that attitude without actually, you know, respecting Arena and, you know, wanting to learn it and just looking at it like you'd farm some materials in WoW, just be like, oh, I'm just going to farm some cards in the Arena. You know, like turn your brain off and just invest the time, that won't do. You actually need to learn Arena. Respect it.
We potentially could novice into a Shadow Strike or a DID here.
That would be pretty good. Using a Burgle's not terrible. But if you didn't have the one charge, I think the Priestess would be good. So would you develop the Priestess here if you go Novice and you whiff? You just go Novice, Harvest, Priestess?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, let's Novice. Yeah, we got to get rid of that charge at some point. So.
Swashbuckler now?
Yeah, that's better.
Harvest Golem?
Yes, Harvest Golem facing far. 4-4. Far left will do. Yeah.
Face, remove the shield main?
Yeah, I take the 5. We've got Armor Smith as well, we're going to unleash the taunts. And Burgle might net us a little bit more life gain as well. So.
He didn't play a bog or an obsidian. I'm happy.
Oh, he's trading. That's good. I mean, obviously he protects his monkey, so...
Yeah.
Might be used for Unleash the Taunts.
You want a burgle?
Not necessarily. I think here is definitely an option to, like, protect hero power and then either play to Young Priestess or to Armorsmith.
Yeah. There's a lot of weapons we could get from Burgle that would be very good here.
So if we would Burgle and we'd whiff, we'd have to dagger, go in, you'd keep a 4-1. Whereas the 1-1 taunts from Protect the Thing like actually have use here, if you ask me. Because he's going to have a 4-1.
So we go Protect the Taunts. What else to finish off?
So... Unleash the Taunts happens. Can we dagger? Would you rather play 2 Priestess, or is it like just asking to get ghouled? It's probably asking to get ghouled, right? Yeah, let's play Armorsmith.
Do we dagger here? Or is it better to play like Armorsmith Echoing Ooze?
No, I think Armorsmith dagger and take down the monkey is fine.
Okay.
So what's your argument for not daggering here?
Oh, I was thinking on the other lines. I just actually didn't was just trying to shoot out another option to you really quickly because I wasn't thinking along the Armorsmith line. I was thinking on the Burgle for a while.
Yeah, I think you do this because if he has Ghoul, you still have the 1-4 to trade into his guy. If he doesn't have Ghoul, you're in a pretty good position. Then you start to gain armor quite a bit here. Yeah.
Ooh, that's nice.
That is very good.
You want a burgle to start things off?
So if we Shadow Strike, we've got 5 left. Yeah, burgle's fine.
Those are good cards.
Do you want to just go full armor, Smith?
I kind of do.
Well, we're Shadow Striking is 3-5. This is happening, right?
Yeah.
So by going full Armorsmith here, you do allow yourself to use his Death Spite properly. Yeah, I think Armorsmith's fine here. And then face and Armorsmith go in. Trade off a 1-1 taunt and face. Lul, armor coming, boys. This feels like Constructed with double Armorsmith, like...
We just need to steal a few executes.
Yep, and then we're there. Oh, man. Mm-mm-mm. Dude.
Okay, now we might be in a little bit of a hurry.
Yes. Stop playing with our food.
We can kill that. Okay. How much armor are we getting?
Getting a lot, right? So every hit is 2 armor. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'd be gaining 6 if we throw in 4 power.
And we get 3 cards?
I think you always end up cold mastering and throwing in the golem. I think there's no other way to start this turn. I'd rather not refuel him here, so throw in the 1-1 taunt. Dear God. Throw in the 1-3. Alright, Death Spite and Priestess. My God. This game, dude. This game.
Okay.
Holy shit. I think middle will do it. Yeah, it's fine. Sponsored by Armor Smiths. It's like easy 8 phase. It's like, lul. Help, help, help. Cards, cards, cards. This guy's like, what the fuck is this meme deck? Memeing our way to the top, guys. That's how you play Arena. Let's go for the memes. Go. Whirlwind. Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah, right? Gain 3 armor, draw a card, lose a 1 drop.
Yeah.
Whee! I guess from his point of view, we've got no good way of killing it, right?
So. Yeah, the death bite's awkward for us now.
It's fine. I think I'll just taunt up and let that live then. Guess we might just sap that to encourage him to play that again, because we have Assassinate.
Yeah, sap double force.
Yep, sap double force, push 5, hold weapon.
Okay. Shredder positioning.
Can't wait for Mage and Assault will come in. I think we've had 2 mages already, so...
That's like that.
Like I said, I don't think Mage is the strongest. I think it's definitely the strongest if you give it room. But that's obviously not how you should play Arena, right? Oh my god. Hey, OP, what the fuck? Nerf, please. Yeah, you can still Walker here. It's okay, man. That's not it, right? No. Sunwalker should be 2nd from the right?
I think so.
This deck is so annoying, yeah. Oh, that's better. Cheers. Cheers, meat. It's definitely an argument for going wide here with the AoE buff that we get from the armor. I think we're always assassinating that because I don't think you want to like trade in your shredder. It's just a good use for assassinate as well. Yeah. Then we're also going face with our dudes. Yeah, I think it's better to go echoing ooze, priestess, thespian this turn, and then we've got a lot of things you can gain armor on.
Priestess first, right?
Yeah, priestess first. Oh wow, rewarded. if we had played the ooze first, the ooze would have split and then priestess would have buffed something, guys. Ordering matters. If mage isn't the strongest, what class is? Once again, this is my opinion. This is by no means like proven or, you know, enormous sample size showing this. This is how I'm feeling the arena right now. I think that Shaman is the strongest class, then Rogue, then Mage. This is when it's played as close to perfect as possible, right? If you had a Hearthstone computer that wouldn't fuck up, I think Shaman and Rogue would be stronger than Mage right now.
I want to start with running an Echoing Ooze and... Or do you want to start with the Flame Juggler?
I think that you're always losing Priestess, and it doesn't really matter. I think you're losing one Ooze and one Priestess, and then your face goes in, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, if... Oh, yeah. Yep.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. Just throw in, so the, you wanna... throw in the Priestess and then use face. Yeah, correct ordering. Sorry, yep. This is absolutely right. You'd miss. I'd miss out on one armor with my one. Good catch.
You want to play Flame Juggler, or you would just want to run in an ooze?
Flame Juggler's fine, honestly. Do we just kill him, or what's it looking like? Data lands, we have 7, 8, 9, 10... No, he's not dead, but yeah. Juggles.
Ooze goes in.
Yeah, ooze goes in, and I think it just DID the other ooze to kill it. And push face.
Could. Okay.
We could
drop
DID.
Engine also?
Yeah, we could DID the armorsmith, but like. I think just dagger hit him in the face is fine.
Alright.
I think that the only thing that does save it from is Deathwing and Sengen gives.
Can't dagger the face.
Oh, okay, never mind. That's fine. I stand by my call, though. I think the only thing that does win it for him is Deathwing, so I think holding this engineer is fine. JohnF246, thanks so much for subbing. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you.
I want at least, what, 4 more health? Ba-bum. So we can end on 30 health.
Oh, he may have stabilized. Well, not stabilized, but he may have prevented lethal with that. So he goes up to 13. We bump in 7, 8, 10, 11. Yep. If he armors up, he's not dead. But then again, you know, he's kind of dead, right? I don't really keep a record of first and second Kagan. It might be somewhere in the bot, but it's not something I can access. I'd have to talk to my guy. Oh yeah, we stayed on 16 health so he couldn't crush her. Yeah. Don't expect to see this account after this, by the way, Kappa. All right, Sean, thank you.
Do you want to drop the Sengen?
Sengen goes for sure. I'm just not sure whether we keep Priestess as well. So if you play Priestess, she goes in on one, probably.
Yeah, I like getting the coin ping out from the mage.
Yeah, it's to what end, right? Because like we don't really have a reward for that. Like we don't get to play a 2-drop very often. If you see my point.
Yeah, I don't know. I have a tendency just to. I think coin firelands into 4 firelands is just a play that if you can remove that option from the mage in the long run, I think it's pretty helpful. It's worth the sacrifice.
I think it's fine to keep it. I'm not sure whether it's correct, but I think that keeping a priest is never terrible, right? So even if we don't play it on one. So the... Now we just do the thing, right?
Yeah. Pass.
Yeah, this is fine. So my whole point is like you play priestess, he coin pings, you dagger, and then you bug dagger. It kind of doesn't make sense. That was the whole point. But yeah, obviously. Double priestess power, puck champ. Man, this thing is so good.
So if he plays a 2 health minion here, it's... Oh, okay. No arcane blast.
Yeah.
Oh, that's, no. It's like a frostbite or something.
That's still fine-ish, right? Yes, burn his coin.
He's low on cards. We have a way to refill.
He can't ping the bug. Oh, my God. Young Priest isn't such a bully in the early game. Yeah. Yep. Bug dagger, followed by Shredder. Damn, guys. Look at this. This mage is like, what the fuck, dude? Chill. Yeah, when Young Priestess is a 1 mana 2/2, it's pretty alright. Alright, as tempting as it is to save one of our guys with a Shadow Strike, I think it's Shredder.
Yeah. Shredder and... I think the buck's more valuable to us.
Yeah, I think Shredder.
I think because the health on the Shredder might not be relevant. We have a Swashbuckler in our hand.
We're probably daggering and shadow striking next turn with that line anyway. So yeah.
Yep.
Yep. Shredder, suck the priestess. This opener you just got here. Yeah, this opener. It's the second time we double priestess.
Versus a mage too. Both times were versus mage.
And this is what I mean, by the way. Mage isn't that scary if you have a good opener because there's a lot of pressure coming in. Mm-hmm. I don't think we can afford to slow down here with this opener. Yeah. I think it's Swashbuckler DID.
Yep.
Or Swashbuckler Water Rally because we're good at the game.
That'd be nice. Ooh. That's better.
Yeah, we'll take that. That's actually pretty decent in our class as well.
Yeah.
So kind of a fancy Silrant Knight here. 4/4 with that effect plus a 1/1. Is Priestess in standard? Yeah, she's in classic.
Looks like DIDing the sheep, dagger into the dancing swords, sheep into the swords. We could also do something else.
Nah, I like the scepter sheep, dwarf, dagger, yep. Let's take one damage dance game. This violet illusionist is broken. This is getting a little iffy because Flamestrike can put him back on it.
Yeah.
Looks like we're going to burgle Tomb Pillager.
Ew. That's such a rough card.
Let's actually find a burgle here. This potential lethal. Like Fireball does it. 12.
Huh. Do you want to just drop a mirror here?
So we're 1 damage of lethal right now.
4, 5, 6.
Because you could technically ten him in the face and suck your thing and have 4. There's no way I'm missing any Q lethal here, right?
Let's see here. 8, 9, 10, 11. I don't think so.
Because we can't Shadow Strike our own dude and then So yeah, Mirror Entity all face. Next turn Dragon's Breath for the kill. Yep.
Weapon in the face?
Yep.
Good mirror.
Good game, bro.
GG.
Yeah, mage is so strong, man. Fuck. Now, obviously, we got a good start, but I want to show the flip side, right? Where mages are so scary if you don't pressure them, but if you pressure them, it's like a putting, it's like falls apart. But a lot of people don't draft or play efficient enough. And then if there is one small inefficiency in your line of play or your draft, and you don't get the pressure mage, they like completely take over and like portal you on 7, 8, and 9. But if you can pressure them hard enough that they can't even use their first portal, it just doesn't feel that good.
Yeah, I think I lose more to mages because they either drop a Zombie Chow or a Babbling Book on one and then having a bunch of Firelands portals.
Well,
because
that's the thing, right? That gets them to the portal.
Yeah. Yep. It's like I can deal with a 4 Firelands portal deck. I can't deal with the 1 drop to start that deck off.
Yeah. Yeah, this is my one criticism that I really push is that Babbling Book should have never been a card. This is dumb. Like, mage is already really strong at what it does. Don't give them reliable early game. This is not a good game design.
You want to drop the Tauren?
I don't know if Pit Snake is worth it. And this is your whole like,
yeah,
mini coins defias thing, right? Yeah.
It's a thing that like when you're having a bad time in Arena, it's so frustrating because you just feel like whichever line you go with, you're going to get punished, right? So. Like, this is where I get a little Bible thump baby ragey, like, oh, no matter what I do, something can, it's like, he'll have the better line.
So I don't think I hate keeping the Pit Snake, but it's...
If we find a Young Priestess, then turn 2.
On the other hand, if we just keep Thespian, we do increase our chance for a good 4, which is really what we need.
We could also save Pit Snake for 3 because we're low on... Where like we could go Thespian on 2, see if that taunt survives.
I think it's okay to keep the Pit Snake. M. Kong, thanks so much for subbing. Welcome. Glad to have you here. Turn 7, so redaggering and playing a 2-drop for 4 mana. I'm actually gonna have look at that in a sec.
I like keeping the Pit Snake for three. We can probably Flame Juggler next turn and hopefully drop the Thespian and the Snake.
I agree with the Thon to put the Thespian mine. So I'm going to read this question for the previous game. Redaggering and playing a 2-drop for 4 mana on turn 7. Holy shit, shit. I'm going definitely don't hate Dagger. I'm definitely, you know, considering it, right?
I think I would just go with the Juggler, get stats. Or the Thespian even, but
I think Dagger supplements the Juggler fairly well though. But let's think
I might go with the Thespian just because it gives that Juggler a chance to clean up a 3 with a Thespian. If it's a 4 health.
Thespian makes Buckcoin Dagger terrible though. Like
Yeah.
Up to the point we lose. If we Flame Juggle and he plays a 3, play Thespian Snake. If we Dagger and he plays a 2.
If he Buckcoins Dagger, then Flame Juggler potentially, I think, brings us back.
I like the Dagger here, honestly. I think we can do it. I think that he might Dagger back and then we just Thespian Snake. He might play a 3-2, then we Juggler, get lucky. Saving Shadow Strike. I don't get your question, Beast Haven. I'm sorry. You can't Shadow Strike face, right? Just running that out. So if we Thespian Priestess here, we have a 3-3. He would have to Dagger in the 2-2 into the Thespian, freak kill, then we stab the Imani or we Juggles.
I like the Thespian Priestess here. If we can get the Dagger out of him on turn 3, I think we're going to be quite happy. I think that's
good. Yep. Now obviously he made an insanely strong play, right? With this line, obviously getting the Juggler down is better. I don't think you ever Thespian on 2 there, though. I think the Buckcoin Dagger is so strong.
Yeah, it's backstab. There's a lot of things that... Speaking of...
Yeah, he's definitely running away with the game here, but one of his things goes to 1. Probably the Imani.
Wanna just DID here?
Yep, stab the 5-1 DID. He definitely burned a lot of gas. With that anomaly, but he's getting rewarded for it.
So. Yeah. And Swashburglar can really help him refill if he has those.
Yes, please.
See, with his deck, I don't know. This Refreshment Vendor is just a card that I'd be avoiding if I were him.
First instinct would be to kill the 3-5, drop the Snake and the Tauren. He can't get through the Tauren and kill the Snake.
Yeah, I like that.
But the Tauren in the middle, I guess. Well, let's kill the 3-5 and start with that. So Snake.
Well, I mean, unless we want to do a Flame Juggler play, I guess there's. But I think we're.
We've locked in on the Tauren Pit Snake line. I just want to make sure where it goes. So if the Tauren's in the middle, bump, bump, that's the best play, right? Yeah, we want the Tauren in the middle. But we had lethal regard to Beast Haven. I don't know what you're talking about, because we had the 4-4, right? We had the 4 damage. Actually has betrayal. Cool. Like we had the we had the thing, so we were always fine. Pretty crazy how much tempo this guy's got.
You want a novice first? Because I think we go Flame Juggler Dagger probably. You want a burgle for SI.
Alternatively, you could juggler and if it fails, you could burgle. Not saying that's good, but I'm saying that could be a thing that we need.
So I don't think there's really any things specifically we're looking for with novice. Yeah, so I'm fine with flame juggler. You want a flame juggler first?
Just thinking what we could land. Oh, we could novice into Ascension or something. Good four drops here are probably good. So I think novice is fine. Yeah. I hope you like my invention. Okay, juggler. The knights wait where it lands first and then dagger, yeah. So we don't give too much away from our hand. If we insta dagger, it's like, alright, you don't have a two. Because you were gonna do that anyway. It's alright though, Beasthaven. Feel free to ask those questions, but I was confused because we had lethal regardless, so I didn't really see your point. But like I said, don't let that discourage you from asking questions. I don't mind answering them.
Myrtle?
Yep.
Nice. Illusionist, remove the SI?
Yeah, and then I'd probably still cultist because we have Betrayal.
Mm-hmm.
And it's technically plus 5 HP, which is probably worth the one drop. But yeah, he's been going really, really ham. And obviously, if we go with your line, the 2-drop, we're in a much better position.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's hard to... I don't assume the high wind rogue to be the super aggro guy.
Mm-hmm.
I think the high wind rogue is more the reactive dude, and I felt that we were burning a little bit too much by not daggering there. God, dude, could you like stop for 1 second?
Yeah.
It's like, choo-choo! Premium rogue cards coming through. I guess we're 8-0. I guess if you look to the counter, it's like, okay, we're 8-0. This is supposed to happen, sorry. So,
Burgle?
Yeah, we're burgling into an SI, and then we betray the 5-2, and then we SI the 5-2. So that would make Betrayal 3, and then we could just Betrayal the... No, that's not true.
It doesn't work on...
Yeah. It's good that you stopped me there.
I think I do like the Betrayal on this, on to remove the Pillager, because we have the Assassinate in hand. That allows us to go Swashburglar Ooze.
Would you betray the Pillager to kill the tank? Because you have one damage things. Let's Swashburglar and find an SI and not talk about this.
Yeah.
Oh, that doesn't do anything.
I feel like we should remove damage off the board. I think I would betray... So we want to Ooze here, right?
Yeah, I want to Ooze. I'm alright if you want to betray the 3-4 to kill a 5-2. I think it's totally fine.
What do you want to do?
Let's betray the 3-4. It's safe. It's fine.
Oops.
I just think that now the spider tank farms you little dudes, but it's definitely a thing where you can suddenly start to drop really low.
Yeah.
So with my line, we kill that. He stabs the 1-1, he jams 5 face. We have 2 oozes to go back into that. I mean, it's all about what you value. This definitely gives us more time.
Don't be stealth. I am the blade. Okay, that's...
Wow, this guy missed out on a heal. Nice.
So you want to Shadow Strike the Illum?
Yeah, Shadow Strike the 5-4. Probably go face for 1 Peddler Conceal.
Sounds good.
Seems like a good moment to use it.
So I'm getting some lag on my end. Okay, there we go.
Yeah, I mean, you give him a license to smork here, but he's always had that option, and he could ping for free right now with the Illusionist. Oh, if only the Peddler could reduce that, that'd be so sick.
Yeah.
Bam. Get that Betrayal out, get the 5-6. He healed, so you could Shadow Strike phase. Yeah, but I mean, he missed out on 1 heal. Right, he could have had more. Wow, right. I would have daggered first. I think pushing 1 damage is quite important.
So it looks like we assassinate the spider tank, the ooze goes into the buck, the peddler...
Let's
start with that?
Yeah. Har har har. So we con dagger and beneath the grounds. And dagger's kind of useful.
Okay, so the ooze goes into the buck, right?
Well, we're assassinating the 5-5. That's happening.
Yeah.
And I think the 5-6 goes into the illusionist.
I think so also.
Yeah.
Ooze goes into Buck.
Not always. You could kill the 1-1 for free and dagger the Buck, right? So his face goes into the 5-2. His 2-2. It's kinda relevant, yeah. Yeah, I think I
You wanna dagger here over beneath the grounds? I think.
Yeah, you keep an additional like 1 damage dude. It's quite, and you remove more.
Alright. So remove the Buck.
Remove the Buck.
With the Buck with dagger.
Kill the 1-1 with the 1-2. Yep. You see, this way you keep 1-1s, which are pretty relevant against this 2-2. So.
I'm just.
You're looking at how do we win this? Oh, we get 3 Nerubians here, or just 1, yeah. Right? You just come on.
Yeah, it's just like we've talked about this before. Like I sometimes go in for the lucky play. Here, I feel like the lucky play is kind of also. Might be our best chance to win. You want to remove the sensei, drop both
play cards. Play out, redagger. Yep. I think this just gives you a moment where you get control back of the board. Whereas with the ambush, where it's only 1 turn delayed, and I don't know, you'd have to hit 1 immediately to make the difference.
So we have Ascension left, right?
We do have Ascension left. Tarn's been used. Ooh, Kraken.
Kraken.
GG.
Let's start.
Yeah, that was too much. I think even with the 2-drop, that's too much, but yeah. Because he's shown to have the backstab and such, so he would have gone through.
All right, ready for the next one?
Let's wait like half a minute or so, because it's 8-0. I think we get matched against that guy pretty fast. There's not that many 9-0 opponents, so
yeah.
I think the system's pretty likely to match us with him. All right, let's give it a go. Nope, this is my Sunday attire, Sawash. Dressing up for the stream. Are you doing a Shaun of the Dead cosplay? I thought I was wearing a shirt. Alright.
Different rogue. You want to...
So the master goes.
Yep.
I think you want to drop stays.
You want to drop the illusionist?
I think it's fine. I think it's almost all. I think it's almost okay to also keep 2-3s and dig for 1. Get that start. Like I think Thespian Golem keep is fine. It's flexible. Allows us to go 1-2-3 save coin, or we can coin dagger, coin Thespian dagger. So.
Alright. So keep Thespian illusionist and Golem.
I ditched the illusionist. I think Thespian Golem keeps fine. Yeah, it's tempting, but I think if you keep illusionist, you ditch Thespian, and I don't think that adds more flexibility. Nice. That works.
Pass.
So pass allows us to buck coin dagger. Playing a 2-drop. Plays his 2. Oh, this is interesting.
I will be your death.
That's good.
Yep.
He's susceptible.
He's frustrated already. Yeah.
Love it. Incredible. So him daggering here, what do? We coin out Harvest Golem and set up Buck Dagger? No. Because any daggers on the Buck. Maybe that's fine. If he plays a 2-3, what do?
Either coin the golem or just play the flame juggler, I would guess.
Yeah, I think I'm fine passing it. Cool. Must have a combi chat. You're not that sharp. So if Flame Juggler hits either, it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
If you dagger down to 2-1, you'd probably have to coin Pit Snake to force his dagger, and it doesn't even force it because you could just put the 2-3 into play 3. So I'm pretty happy playing Flame Juggler here.
Yep.
Nice. Yep. So what this probably results in is his dagger and the 2-1 into our guy, Two-Face, and then we get the buck.
Yep.
Oh, goes for the
backstab.
Yep. Does that change our line?
Harvest Golem now? If he plays like Ascension here, we have the sap next turn. I like the Harvest Golem.
I'm just thinking if we ever get the hero power this turn. So with Harvest Golem, he pushes another four face, most likely.
Yep.
He plays a thing, we sap the thing. We've got 2 or 3 mana left.
Yep. It means we can clean up pretty well with a dagger.
Yeah, the problem is I kind of want to taunt and Pit Snake. Okay, Harvest Golem's fine. We wait one more turn for a swing turn with this up. It's good. That fucking coin, man, it's useless on turn 10. Yeah, turn 4, turn 5, it's still pretty good. Almost feels like a shame sapping that. Whoa! Whoa, what are we doing? Yeah, you're the aggressor, trade everything. What the fuck was that? Holy shit! That's 8-1, so I'm scared. Like, he must have like a crazy value deck, and he just started out really fast, because I have no idea how he can make that line otherwise.
I can see it, right? He has Netherspite Historians or something, and he's just been generating like crazy stuff with this deck. So the thing is, by him doing that play, like, I'm not scared of a Shredder getting sapped right now.
Yeah, I mean, he's lost all pressure. We no longer have to sap, right?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking it's Shredder pass. Just trying to go over what else.
And if he pops the Shredder and that Drake takes 2 damage from our 2 drop,
this
we've
is
got
fine.
Bucks.
Just Shredder's cool.
That was odd, right? Like, it almost can't be right.
And sorry, guys, we don't mean to be disrespectful towards our opponent by any means, right? This is not us saying, oh, what a bad player. We are just wondering what triggered him to start to clear our board there. This is unfortunate.
He has a pint. Like, yeah. Okay, so sapping the Drake, Buck Dagger, we could with sap Buck Dagger. It's 5.
So
coin out.
We buck and we dagger to 2-2. This is happening.
Yeah, I don't think we need to sap that.
No, I think we can use the Thespian to block him off.
Do you want to get out a Young Priestess also?
I think so, but we'll Buck Dagger and Thespian will do that. Yeah, I think Pit Snake right now does not serve enough purpose, because he can access it with the dagger, so Coin Priestess is good. Hope you win the flip on the buck.
And if he doesn't, like, we assume he has a slower deck, I guess, so maybe him not having 6 mana is a really good thing right now. Stops a Boulder Fist. I mean, a Boulder Fist is fine. I don't know, I'm confused by this rogue.
Yeah, you should by no means have traded. It was a Harvest Golem, he gave it Mega Wind Fury. He made it hit 3 things, his face and 2 dudes. It's very interesting.
Mim Irons Golem. I can't.
So he's gonna have a deadly poison charge.
Yeah, the thing is, if we throw the Pit Snake down with this Cult Master, then like he's gonna.
It's kind of like we let him choose which one he wants to deal with. On the other hand, we could also go for the redagger value here and play 2-1s and say you have to kill Pit Snake, and then next turn we Cult and get our value. And you have redagger value. I'm not saying that's the play, but I'm saying it's definitely an option, right?
I think I want to go save the sap.
I wouldn't sap. I think that you, like, one play is either kill it with the Cult Master, play the ones, or kill it with face, drop the ones, redagger. Like, redagger first, obviously.
Yeah.
I like face into his guy, redagger, sack the buck, play the ones.
Okay.
This may seem too greedy, but I feel like we may run out of steam if we just throw out the cult. Whereas now he has a 3 damage weapon, which he probably has to put onto the pit snake, right? And then next turn we have Sap and Cult to stabilize. We can cash in the Priestess for a card. We have our 2 damage dagger generated. I just think at this point, especially with Sap in hand, Cult Mass is worth more than Pit Snake. If we didn't have Sap in hand, I'm all for your play, by the way.
Okay.
Interesting.
I think we Sap and Cult Master.
Yeah, I think so too. That means if he daggers the Priestess, we get the card. Yep.
Yep.
Seeing how it turned out, do you like the line or not?
How it turned out, I think it's fine. I'm just like, I just think with the cult master in hand, all he needs is an Ironforge Rifleman, and the cult is going to become very, very hard to get any value out of anyways. I would have taken the one card.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You want to hold the dagger?
I'd hold the dagger, yeah. With Burgle, it seems like we're going to get enough mana to spend. Well, he needs more than one damage, right? He needs 2 damage plus his dagger here. Nice.
Well, I mean, on the turn, like, instead of him playing the runs, if he had, you know, 1 damage out of hand,
Oh, you mean to clear the Priestess? Okay.
Burgle first?
Yep, Burgle's good.
Oh, man.
So if you ooze here, the chance that he just trucks face is pretty likely. Because he knows we have the 2 damage weapon to go back in, so Skulker would hit. We could go for a really big swing with Dwarf and Skulker. So we know he has runs, right?
Yeah.
One, two.
I'm fine with the ooze here.
So you can actually get some crazy stuff done with ooze, because that's 2, Dwarf's another 2, faces another 2. You can pop the runs and then flurry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think you ooze here and just chill. But if you play a dwarf, he kills it and plays runs, and that's no good for us. The reason why I'm doing this is because I know he's probably going to play slow.
Yep.
And if we burn the gas here, if we just dwarf, it's kind of awkward. Yeah.
Yep.
And he should never trade here because we have the web. Oh, now he can trade. Now he can trade. Okay.
Do you want to Tomb Pillager and DID?
You want to go into the runs or not?
I think so.
So the obviously the 2-3 screws everything up.
Yep.
Is there a world where we flurry here? 2 flurry. So it doesn't kill the 2-6, right?
No. It'd be flurry and Tomb Pillager then? That can work. So, or we could.
Yeah, I think you go in with your face and then you flurry and then Tomb Pillager. I don't like the 3-2 getting value when you have 2 AoEs in the hand. I don't think that makes sense. I think he pops the runs this turn and then you Skulker.
Yep. Pass with the ooze.
Yeah, so it feels like what he's going to do is double trade into the Tomb Pillager and then you get the scope.
Yep.
Whereas if we play Pillager that turn, the Bomber gets value killing the Pillager. It's not guaranteed he pops the runs and you are stuck with 2 AoEs in hand and it's really bad. That seems weird, but might have another thing. Oh, wow. Super value.
You have something else?
Yeah.
Deal. This looks pretty good. Ooh. Tomb Pillager goes into the runts.
Yep. And then we skulk.
Ordering because of the top deck series. I mean, positioning it. What are we doing? We're playing a Master of Disguise, right?
Yes, we are. So he will have a 5-2 and a 4-2.
I guess we disguise the Tomb Pillager.
Because it's more reach.
Yeah,
sure.
The DID around, yeah. So, Skulker one
Skulker
side.
On, yeah, Skulker one edge, Master the other edge. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think this has been a pretty difficult game, and I think we read it well, especially the turn where we held, where we just oozed. I think that was very counterintuitive, but it made super much sense knowing he had runs in hand. I don't think he should be trading right now.
Yeah, no, I think. I mean, the thing is, his card quality didn't seem so good that he should be going into 8-1.
Yeah. It's weird. He's, yeah, he must have some really fat minions left and just have drawn really light because he's trading so much. It's crazy.
Novice.
Yep.
Huh. I mean, we can play both.
Yeah,
I kind of like it.
It's definitely not out of the question. So let's look at both scenarios, right? Scenario one, we dwarf, we jam six face. I guess that's always happening, right?
Yep.
Okay, so we dwarf, we jam six face. Our opponent's on 12 HP. If we dagger down the shield, he will trade into the 3-1. He will stab the 1-1. We have a 4-4 against his top deck. If we coin out assassinate, we have 8, 9, 10 damage going into his turn. He stabs a 1, he's at 11. We have 9.
The minions on board can get through a bog.
Yeah. I think you coin dagger to hit it and just play this little safer. Because I think we have the read.
You mean just dagger, right?
Yeah, sorry, just dagger. Yeah, for some reason.
Do you want to hit the Scarlet?
I think so, because it frees up your weapon next turn, and should he have something?
Is there any risk that we're putting ourselves within lethal range?
No, he's not killing us. His card is coin, right? So he has one card. It's not. He can't even like combo a Tinker. I think we will see him trade every time here. Yeah. Honestly, I think if you assassinate, you either win very fast or lose very fast.
Yeah.
So. Oh, beautiful. Right. Let's go. Yeah, play both.
Play both?
Face, face. Yeah, seems good. I wouldn't coin re-dagger because Harrison. Thank you. Even if he sabotages, it's not enough, so. But the Harrison could give them up.
I want to say he should have won this game.
Yeah, if he jams phase earlier, he could jam phase this turn. He can combo Tinker, that's what the coin, why not? Yeah, okay, he can combo, I mean, he's not playing anything to kill us with that, right?
No.
But yeah, obviously he can combo it, he can just coin the air. But the Tinker on the dude doesn't do anything, right? Because it's still 1 HP. So he'd have to use his phase into the 1-1 and then push phase, but that's kind of weird.
Right.
Yep.
Man, I just wish some of the opponents at 2-2 would make these mistakes.
That's where the pros hang out, man. Right. He threw it one turn where he traded it all. Yes.
Yeah.
For some reason, he felt the need to kill our Harvest Golem rather than hit our face, and that just made no sense from the standpoint because we had the card advantage, like we were going to win the long game there. Obviously, it became quite a difficult game after that. We really had to choose our moments for the swing turn, but. Valera versus Uther. I will fight with honor.
Watch your back. So dropping the Cult Master, right?
Yeah, I don't think you keep Shredder simply because we've got ones and we need ones. So.
Yeah, we've got a lot of ones and we actually have a lot of fours. So even though Shredder's kind of the premium for it, yeah, I would look for ones here. So just keep the Thespian?
Yeah, just the Thespian.
Any thoughts that we look so hard for ones that we drop the Thespian?
I definitely considered it, but I think that's a little crazy. I think a 2-drop always comes in handy, especially something with taunt like this. With double Priestess, double Pit Snake in the deck, that's pretty sick to have a taunt. Okay, so definitely not a good mulligan, right? But hey!
There we go.
looking up. There we go.
That's, I need a decent two drop.
Worked out.
Oh, man. So, do you want to play one of the best two drops in the game?
You mean a Thespian or?
The mini bot?
Yeah, we'll go with mini bot. I really like Thespian, that's what I'm memeing. I think he's super undervalued by people.
He's good. I like saving the Thespian for the same turn Pit Snake comes down.
For sure, for sure. Yeah, and just developing the Divine Shield early now makes much more sense.
Alright, I want to preserve the Divine Shield because we're going to be weak to Consecration with a lot of our plays.
I feel like the play here is either Thespian Snake, suck the 1/1/2 face, or Dagger Snake, go face for 3.
We have a lot of refill in the deck. I think I'm okay with Pit Snake and Thespian and running the 1/1 in.
So what exactly are we playing around by doing that? If he had Muster, he would have coined Muster, right?
Yep.
So why do we feel the need to run the Thespian out so fast? Because Dagger's going to do work against Paladin no matter when, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because you're only developing one additional power with the Thespian, because preserving the 1/1 and having the Dagger charge gives you 2 reach.
So he could have the 3 attack weapon. I don't think he would use that here. In that case, he would use that on the Pit Snake.
That's fine for me.
Isn't terrible.
I think Pit Snake Dagger's okay. I think your logic is good, but I think that we're okay playing it slightly greedier this turn.
Yeah, this is fine. I think if we had like a Burgle in hand, I'd be more willing to go out into the board, go with the Thespian Pit Snake.
But I mean, you're really only developing one additional power, right? It's like, it's not even that tempo-oriented compared to this. And this gives you flexibility of 2 additional, like, one damage sources instead of just the 3-in-1. True silver? Sure. So I think this is...
Sinjin?
Like, yeah, now he's Sinjin, and I don't think there's anything he can develop that we're really sad about. So face with our dudes.
Yep. We have another Pit Snake in the deck, right?
Yeah, we do. Yeah, I think you Sinjin here. I don't think want to give him the hit into the Shredder. Taldingo! So did you consider that as kind of a punish or like something you wanted to play around, or is that something where like if he wants to coin a true silver?
If he wants to coin a true silver into Pit Snake, I agree. Like I am fine with that.
Okay.
Especially with the Ascension that we can draw up there.
Don't forget to ask for Tyrion before you play the Burgle. I don't know, I think I'm going for Edric this game. I think Edric is pretty fun as well. Because we have to prepare ourselves for the ultimate test.
Dun, dun, dun. So, I'm just thinking about a potential assassinate next turn. 7 damage into his face would leave him at 16.
Yeah. 18 effectively with the thing. Happy Rag.
He plays Ascension. I was about to say, if he plays Ascension, that... I think might be worth it. Or not.
Or not.
DID the mini bot, run the Swashburglar in because MCT exists.
It's most likely what I want to do. DID the mini bot. Shield on the 1/1 go in. Yeah, you were instantly thinking the same as I was. I was like, I think this 1/1's not going to make it through the turn.
Can hold the dagger?
Yeah, I think 4/2 is fairly likely. So. Wow. Not having a good day.
Also fine with this. Minions go face, right?
Yeah, minions go face, Shredder gets played in the middle, and I'm okay with hit him in the face with the dagger as well. So our opponent is at 12 life. We have 8, 10, 11 damage.
Yeah, so Thespian comes down.
Well, not always, right? Because MCT might be one of the only ways for him to stabilize here.
So if he MCTs the Shredder, right, we have an Assassinate to get through a taunt later. We can drop Drake, Priestess, and just continue to push the face. I think I would just drop the Thespian.
Okay, let's do it. That's fine. No occasion, guys. It's just Sunday. Sundays I dress up for the stream. Good game.
GG.
He's dead.
No barn into rag light lord.
That would be pretty okay. Probably wouldn't be enough to win this, which is sick, yeah. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'll queue up quickly. I wouldn't mind running into that paladin again, I think.
Yeah.
He does have a true silver.
For sure.
But I think our deck is, you know, much more susceptible to AoEs than something like a true silver. It's actually...
I think our deck is just good against Pally. So. I will fight
with honor. Watch your back. Echoing Ooze, not a bad card early versus a Pally.
Flame Juggler stays, right?
Yeah, drop the Assassinate.
Drop the Assassinate, definitely. I don't think you keep Ooze just because Dagger's probably more flexible because it has charge. So I think I'd keep Juggler Illusionist.
Yep.
But yeah, definitely not a bad card to Ooze against Pally. It's just that our hero power is so darn good.
Ooh.
Options, we like options. Will there always be a white shirt? I alternate between black and white right now, but I will slowly venture out in the slightly more adventurous colors. I know I said venture into adventure, but fuck it. So this is the turn where I don't hate coin daggering, but
yep.
I think because the 2/3 drops, the priest is really not that bad, right? So if we Priestess and he does not have a 2/3, he's kind of screwed no matter what, right?
So if we Priestess and he hero powers, Flame Juggler, if he misses, go face with the Priestess, or trade? Or just dagger?
Don't even hate daggering, but I think Priestess and go from there is fine.
Yeah. No.
Adventures like Kappa Pride, pink shirt. I'll probably go shirt shopping with shirt and tie shopping with the girl. So she'll advise. All right.
This looks seeming familiar.
This does seem familiar indeed.
Flame Juggler?
Yeah, Flame Juggler. I think this is a different turn or not?
This is also seeming familiar.
So
we went face last time.
Yeah, but we have coin. That's the same, right? Yeah. If he has coin, this is very different because he can coin Silver Moon Portal. But without this, I'm okay. Could you offer us delivery address and your shirt size so we can contribute to future adventures? I guess we could do that. Yeah.
My thought is Senjin.
Yeah, so true silver, he double trades. It's kind of awkward.
Silver Moon Portal doesn't get through the Senjin.
Yeah. Silver Moon Portal is the big thing as well where I'm looking at.
Blessing of Kings is always rough.
So Shredder gets a little less wrecked by that, but I think playing Descension and kill the 2/2 is alright.
Yeah. Could drop a Harvest Golem, but I like getting
the... Harvest Golem plays into the most common out for him, the Silver Moon Portal, yeah. So I like Descension play as well. And we've got a curve with 4/4/5, so...
Yes.
Yeah, look, it's that one thing. Face for Shredder? Yep.
Feels like we might dagger next turn if that's a get down. I guess it's fine that we sack the juggler to it.
Yeah, I think if it's get down, he just free kills a 2-2 and you're in a bad position. I would hope for repentance here. That would have been a nice pickup.
Yep.
All right. Don't screw us over, game.
Just two attack, please. That's good enough. No.
At least he trades. That's something.
Do you want to golem and ooze?
So if the 5-2 kills an ooze and he plays a thing, this is on a one.
If he has a taunt, it's rough for us.
Yeah, taunt's really bad. I don't hate Peddler, just because it's pretty awkward for him. But
if he has another seal,
yeah.
I think you want to go golem ooze.
Is it ever Sylvan Knight here? Kills a 2-2 with his thing, exchange. Golem ends up killing here. No, I think golem ooze is fine. Yeah. If he has taunt, it's annoying. No. I think he's had some pretty good stuff, so we have to try and get something something greedy done. Consecration, pretty much.
No.
But I mean, that's not too bad, right? That takes his turn. Okay.
That's super fine. So it's probably like most likely to be a bench, right? Yeah.
So we're looking at either a 4-3 or a 5-5. Which wouldn't be that bad.
Okay. I mean,
yeah, you just ran the oozes into the 5-2, I think.
Wait, so if we run an ooze into the recruit. Okay, no, let's here. If we go illusionist. Okay, now I was thinking if we run an ooze into the recruit and it buffs the Stormwind Knight, we can drop illusionist dagger and hit the trainer.
But it'd be a 5-5. 5-5 is good against 4-3, right?
Yeah, but he then goes down to one if he trades. Mm.
Make your line. See what happens. I don't like.
Oh, no. I'm just trying to think through. What's the line you want to do here? You just want to run both into the trainer?
Yeah, I think you double trade into the trainer, see what happens. If it buffs the silver hands, probably fine just dropping Peddler. I think Peddler's fine against Snyder.
You want to go illusionist dagger?
No, I think Peddler's better. That kind of makes it awkward for him because
this is
if he doesn't chuck in the 1-1.
This is a bit to give him to a an Aldor.
Sure. But I mean, if you illusionist dagger to 1-1, it's not like suddenly he can't do anything, right? I like this. I like the fact that he just trades it in. Obviously, I make myself slightly more vulnerable to seal and such, but I think he feels that we're running out of steam, and he doesn't know that we're running two swash burglars.
Yep.
So he feels like, all right, I'm stabilizing, I just gotta close it out now, the rogue's out of cards. But little does he know that we're actually not that kind of deck.
All right, Silverhand Knight, dagger?
Seems like always the play. He makes a dude, this is 3-2, probably chucks in the 3 into the 2-2, 3-2 and a 1 into the 4, which means dagger can take this. And Silverhand really makes him trade, which is what we want. We want to keep him trading. Want to be like, this is my last big card, dude, I promise. After this, I'm out of steam, keep trading, please. Yeah, kill the abusive. Oh, perfect. So he's just a very early game-oriented dude. Yep. Okay. Yeah, this is just so much trading. I don't think he can support all this trading. I'm okay with novice. I think we hold the illusionist.
Alright.
Shredder, sure. Stab the 1/1.
Redagger?
I think so. So
we have the like I that this we have to we have to, wait, did we play we played Ascension, right? Is that the
we
other
have
paladin?
Ascension, yeah. So it's
we do have Tauren. A Tauren though.
So what does he do right now? He runs face into the 1/1, jams 3. So Pit Snake technically heals your face for 3, where the 3/3 kills the 1/1, I guess.
I, you know, we also have a Master of Disguise, and I'm fine with holding.
I think Dagger is fine. Yeah, no, Dagger's okay. Just want to make sure because I've had this a lot of times where I'm like, it's not getting played, and then I end up like a little short on health, and it's like, did I really need to keep that Pit Snake? Oh my God! Stop trading, fine. Dude! What the fuck? Okay, well no, I'm gonna keep trading. Well, I mean, we've got the Assassinate, but he doesn't know that. So I think the Scaled Nightmare is definitely a justification for trading here. Oh, beautiful. Assassinate the 2/8, stab the 1/1, Pit Snake, Thespian face. Feels good.
Okay, can he still rogue cards? Let's think about this.
I don't think it matters either way. I think Pit Snake on the left is fine. That plays around both, right? It's either Pit Snake on the left or on the far right. Should probably put his face in first, or would he have died? 7. Yeah, I would have died.
It's a good card.
Yep. Play our cards. Go face with our dudes. Stab a dude.
Any reason to not stab a dude here and to stab face?
So what could he get out of one card?
If he gets Consecration next turn...
One here. I think you do stab a dude. I think Consecration makes it more... makes it better to stab a dude. If you'd set up 2-turn lethal, I'd be fine with that, but...
All right, you want to not redagger for Harrison?
I guess you redagger first and then hit. I think that's a player on the Harrison as well. Like, because I've been told about this a lot where I don't dagger and then they say, what if he plays Saboteur? I'm like, yeah, I guess you're kind of right. So yeah. I've gone with the middle of the road of one charge.
Or if for some reason we need to burgle and then, you know, that, you know, the mana gets filled out that way. GG.
GG. Feels good. Feels good.
Yep.
All right. Time to dig, guys. Hope you're
boy.
Hope you're all good to go. All right. Good to queue, Isher.
All right.
All right, guys. So we have a little tradition here. Whenever we're at 11 wins, we play some diggy diggy ho. See those dwarves are at it. The rock is strategically aimed at my opponent's face, so the dwarves will be digging the opponent's face. So yeah, feel free to put your diggies in the chat. Help us get this 12 wins.
It's like drop it all?
Yep, drop it all. No coin is bad. I guess we just wait for turn 2 and play 2 priestess.
Not this hand, not now.
He went for a full mull though, that's good.
Strategically hover over a card, bluff a one chop.
I like that. Good play, good play.
Which one?
The burgle should be in our hand for a while.
Okay.
Boom.
Like, do we want to play this Buccaneer or do we want to save it for turn three?
You think the miners were better without the rock? Yeah. I feel over time the diggies will be gone, guys. Those two Vikings are terribly inefficient. It's not Vikings. Oh dear god, this is that game where the deck goes like, nope. Dagger pass?
Oh, man. Okay, so he did coin there. Let's hope that he was.
Yeah, let's hope that was like, I've got a flame cannon or a bolt. I need to ping your face now.
But then we just have to deal with that card later.
Yeah, right. Just play a Shredder instead of deal with it. So okay. He's like, oh my god, this is one of those hyper-reactive rogues. No. And we're
when we burgle, we might become hyper-reactive all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Okay. Burgle into a... I'm probably going to want a Blizzard this game.
You should pass on the diggy to someone. Ooh, that's good.
Okay, yes. Okay, so we play the Burgle that we drew most recently because we're bluffing.
Yeah, the other one's a Buccaneer, yep.
Let's go with our...
Whee! Let's get a Tony and a Fireball. Close enough. We got a Wizard and a Fire spell. I'll take it. Hey, Murloc's a Man, thanks so much for the host. How are you guys? Let's do it, guys. Let's do it. Let's get the comeback. Let's do an epic comeback with a skip turn one, dagger turn two, burgle turn three. Portal PogChamp.
He's just sitting there with spells in his hand, isn't he?
It's like, you're not a very roguey rogue, are you? Start like, doing
excuse things. Me, this Twilight Flame Caller isn't very good here.
Like, he pokes us with a stick, like, do something. I think we're looking at Dalaran or Shredder, right?
Yeah, we just don't get much use from that coin right now, correct?
Yeah, and I think the one less health is quite crucial. It makes something like a dwarf notably better.
I think I like the Shredder.
I'm totally fine playing the Dalaran. I think it's he probably wants to play a 4, so I think using the Dalaran into the 2/3 and then playing a 5 is better.
So I think why I'm going to say I like the Dalaran instead of the Shredder, which was my initial thought. So he coined out a 2, probably wanting to play a small removal spell. If he throws a Frostbolt at that Shredder, he's pretty likely to be able to clean up the board pretty well. The Dalaran Aspirant, he's most likely to have to run that Protector in, which I think is good for us.
I think he wants to play a 4. I think that, I mean, especially his deck should be curving out, right, at 11-1, so. Yeah. I think so, we're going to see 4.
So if he plays a 4 also, the Shredder, he could pop the Shredder, makes our DID maybe a little bit less good. Here the DID.
I think we're most likely looking at kill 2/3, play Sylvanas this turn, but we'll see what he does, of course. Maybe we get a really good DID, but I think on curve play is probably fine. Fireball? He pointed that for a sec. Shouldn't be a minion. Or maybe a buffer.
A DID?
Yeah, so
would be fine with the DID.
The fourth card from the right, third card from the left, pretty much center, is targetable. So we're looking at a removal spell or a buffer, and he's debating between the card next to it, so that could maybe be the small removal. Hasn't targeted this one yet. Okay. So he's taken up the role of aggressor with this play.
Yep.
If we choose to go for the 5 mana card here and go in, we could use the 3/2 and the ping or the creeper into the 4/4. 2/3 goes into the 2/2. We'd have to use our 3/5 into the remaining of the shield and stab the 2/3. Whereas the other line is the Dark Iron Dwarf, Or Senjin. Senjin's not terrible either.
I think I like the Dark Iron Dwarf here.
So next turn we've got six.
This is looking like a deck that been like that can really, like, you know, he might have Dire Wolves. He might be looking. This might be a token mage.
I think the DID is fine here indeed. Just get that taunt out of the way. I think this is a pretty crucial turn, but I think this is fine. So we give up two power to have the option of using our Dalaran Aspirant into a minion next turn, which I think is worth it. Because this turn could be an assassinate. He just drops a fatty here and we assassinate, kill his board. It's looking pretty good. Yeah, rogues and shamans are pretty good right now, guys. What can I say? There's the one guy. This feels like trade. Sure, hope he does.
Yep.
Nice. Doesn't happen very often, but I think we're the control against mage here. The other game's been playing pretty aggro. Okay, he's not gonna give us a use for our dagger yet.
Oh man, Firelands Portal becomes 5. Why didn't Blizzard just print it as a 5, right?
Yeah, stupid 7. So no coin on his side, right?
Yeah.
Coined out the Sun Fury. So he's playing 6 mana next turn.
I think I like the, let's see here.
Is it ever just like go into the creeper, stab a dude, Senjin, redagger, put the pressure on him to ping the dwarf?
I think I'd rather remove the Zubat and drop the peddler.
Why?
I'm scared of this mage having a lot of reach, being very aggressive. I want to keep my life total as high as possible in this game.
You're literally just killing one. I like my play. Senjin, kill the spider, stab a spider.
Redagger. Okay, so running the DID into the Haunted Creeper.
And then stab a spider, Senjin, redagger. So what this does is it makes him ping Senjin. Yeah. So you don't like this because you run out of your taunt, right? You want to keep this for your life total later on? Or?
Mm-hmm.
So what I like about this is he now practically has to ping, which means he plays a 4, which means Portal gets playable. I think funneling his play into the ping here is quite important. I think if you ethereal, you give him a decent remove, you give him a decent development, because he doesn't have to ping.
Yeah.
But the taunt really, like, killing the creeper aggressively there just says, okay, if you don't use your hero power here, this dwarf is going into something else next turn, so you can't afford not to ping here.
Yeah. I was just, if he does have removal, which I guess he wasn't showcasing, then the 1-1 gets to clear the DID. It looks like he doesn't have, I guess he just has a lot of firelands.
You're afraid of Fireball Senjin, 1-1 goes in and he plays a 2 and rams 3 with the Zubat?
Mm-hmm.
That's essentially it. Okay, that was a legitimate period. Flame Cannon? Wow.
So, Firelands Portal for him next turn, right?
If he goes in with the 1-1, Flame Strike. If not, Firelands Portal.
Flame Strike. Ooh. Wait, whoa.
I think that's bluffing. That's bluffing. He's like, I'm going to make him think I want to go in with the 3, and then, you know, he's gonna think I don't have it.
So, if we play the...
So instinctively, I want to portal his Mana Worm and just say, your Flame Strike is not good enough here. I mean, hopefully.
I think I want to go with Peddler and Flame Juggler, but...
If you Peddler Flame Juggler, he Flame Strikes, trades his 3-3 in your Peddler Gems 3 phase. Not to mention you could Burgle later on and Peddler them.
Yeah. So you want to go Firelands Portal into
I want to portal the Mana Worm and make it more awkward for him, yeah.
5 health, please.
Thank you. Okay. It's not too bad.
Yeah. And even if he does have a Firelance portal of his own, he can't... He
can't ping, right?
He can't ping, yeah.
So this is annoying for him. Burgle for value? You can't burgle your guys.
There were some things that would have been really sad about that Firelance portal, but we hit the average, right? The average is 4 or 5.
Your hand is so stacked that burgling on that turn is just stupid, guys. You can't burgle that turn.
Oh, are they wanting burgle now? You can't afford to draw there.
Ooh, okay, so this gets discounted, right? Because it's another class? Yeah.
Oh, yeah!
At 0 mana.
Nice. Okay.
So next turn, we could potentially burgle Ethereal.
Burgle, Peddler, Avenge. I like it.
And God knows what else we can play.
Like this, I think we, like, if he doesn't do anything else here.
Yeah, if he chills here, I'm okay with it, because the Peddler puts you out of range as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going up to 10 cards. That's fine, right? Yeah.
And then by if we just do double fours, we're just going to be giving him like.
Now it's great to play slow because he's playing slow, because you want to match that. If you overdevelop here, you give him his play. So yeah.
So let's go burgle.
Yeah, burgle.
Those are nice.
Those are nice. Yeah. Play Peddler and trade. I'm okay holding, and yeah, Avenge.
Yeah, nice. Hold the dagger.
Yeah, hold the dagger. Our hand is super stacked, so we're gonna need mana to play things. Combo breaker! Boom! This Peddler, man, it was our last pick, and we were hunting for it.
We talked a little bit about this in the draft, right? Where it's like we have a mid-range deck that like it can go really into a long game with the burgles, right?
Yeah.
And basically how slow this mage has been playing, he's allowed us to.
Oh,
I think that might be an okay assassinate target.
That's reasonable.
Yeah, so assassinate, and we then have 4 mana, which to me would say Shredder.
So assassinate is due to push 10 face. I think we can afford to push face here. Let's do a little math and see if we can set up 2-turn lethal.
So Tomb Pillager, a little bit weaker to AoE, but it doesn't give him that Doomsayer out. Gives us a coin also.
I don't hate mana. Mana elemental, water elemental even.
Water elemental and then a 2?
I wouldn't play into the MCT.
Yeah, I think I just like the Shredder here.
Yeah. Alright, Shredder in the middle. That's fine. Dig,
dig. Oh. I even forgot about that Avenge for a second. That's another resource that we have that's huge.
Yep.
Like, he needs a polymorph too, I think. Keep in this game.
Why would we bait out the Flamestrike turret? Why do we care? Like, we still have 2-6 health minions. We can probably finish the game before Flamestrike, like before we are run out of things to play into it.
Firelands? He wouldn't wait. That's been this card he's held for a while, right?
Yep.
It shouldn't be a Firelands, because he shouldn't have ran that one when you...
Mulch.
Okay, if we get another... if we get a Peddler from this... Wait.
We have a dragon.
We have a dragon. There we go. Aw, worst target. Polymorph. Hey, there's the polymorph that he needed. That would have been...
Awkward on the Shredder.
Yeah.
Stop resisting, opponent. So, 5 phase for sure.
I kind of... Do we want a Pillager down this turn?
I feel like Water Ally has to come down. I don't think we have to play around the Flamestrike, so...
Do we still want to play around MCT?
Maybe not. But I know the Water Ally needs to come down.
Okay, so Water Ally comes down.
So that's 7 damage. If we play the Pillager, we've got 9, 12.
I think I like Pillager and Harvest Golem.
Ever go Twilight Guardian Pillager? No, that loses art. Harvest Golem Pillager is fine.
This is just, like, if he finds that Flame Strike, this is just, this is not giving him too much. And we get to keep a Silverhand Knight to refill after
Igaeli. Yeah, and you keep your, we were pretty certain you had the Flame Strike, right? Because he even tried to sell that he didn't have it. I think that made it that much more obvious he had it.
Shady. Looks what's on the board. It's our good old friend.
He's back. Can I get some angel thumbs for the barber, please, guys? It's like, he's back.
Oh my
he
gosh.
Made it.
Holy. We need a brewback card.
So we're dishing out six. That's happening.
Yeah. I like getting out the six health minion here.
Yeah, so I'd play the paladin card first.
The Templar.
Yeah, the Templar. And then the six health minion. And then I just stab his face, I think. Keep the damage rolling.
Yep.
Out of Barber's back. Feels good, man. My favorite card to put it in context for the people that are wondering why there's this ban there. Yep, number two.
Double Flame Strike Mage. I've never seen this before.
Crazy.
initially, I just want to go Shredder Silverhand, three of the face, but you can.
I think it's a good turn to coin as well, so I play the Flame Juggler as well.
Yep, so Flame Juggler first?
Yeah, and Juggler first. Silverhand Shredder. And I'd push phase. I wouldn't trade. Just in case he finds that next Flame Strike. Because that's pretty much the only out here, which means hitting him in the face is better, I feel. Then again, we do give up our Shredder dude, but yeah. I feel like now we can probably close it out with just daggering.
Yep. Frost Nova Healbot. Frost Nova Brewback to Healbot. Triple Flame Strike. Oh no, there goes the mana that we give instantly gain back.
Down to 9. Up to 10. Play our minions, stab his dudes.
Yeah, seems good.
Alright.
Cast remove both of those. Fourth Flame Strike?
At this point, you can start to go like Portal, Frostbolt or something.
Let's hope he plays a Bog Creeper. That is win
good.
The Joust. I want him to win the Joust.
Yeah,
just,
you want him to win
just,
the Joust.
Just so we can do this. It's a wow, incredible. Man, you have a chance now.
You must feel a little bad, you know, just burning through that third Flame Strike and be like, stop beating me. You're not supposed to have things. GG, guys. We got there.
Woo!
Didn't,
good run.
Didn't have a fourth Flame Strike. Feels bad, man. Good run. Yeah, you know, I think this kind of hopefully, you know, proves my point of how in Rogue at least I'm much less worried about curve and much more about just having the right things, just having enough to stay alive and then having enough to add value them. Not too worried about the just the curve.
That double burgle I think made the deck what it is. It's helped so much there. Share my screen in a second.
Nerd Cred, thanks so much for subbing. Welcome. Yeah, you can share your screen. Just let me know when that's done. It's on here. I'll be at 12 in a minute too. Awesome, Lightning. Congrats. It's loading. One sec. Yep, we're good. Let's open up. Yeah, really happy that we pushed for the second burgle. So,
all right, nice. This will helps me recover a little bit from all the gold I've been bleeding out recently.
Money. So good. Yep. And I'm so happy that what we talked about in the draft actually really, you saw it come into play where we drafted those pit snakes that really pushed the opponents back in the early game when they weren't mage, and then we have the draw to kind of overpower the mages, and sometimes just curve out and beat them. So awesome. Miami Andy, thanks so much for subbing. Welcome.